to another day of Dota 2 Wonder. I am back and ready. Last time we were on, we had a very successful day. We had 3 wins, one of which was a double down, so that's 4 wins worth of MMR, and 1 loss, no big deal. I was actually wrong. Last time I said I think I won 75 MMR. I think I did the math, and it was 76. The reason why is because if you consider these, it's carrying a negative 1. Together, these are 77 minus 1 is 76. Not that important. Really didn't need to correct my 1 MMR math mistake, but I did it anyway. So there you go. So let's just make sure that my stream has loaded fully. Oh, yeah, I can hear myself just fantastically. So that's cool. I will start queuing up now. We are at 3,186, which is fantastic. Dota 2 has released a matchmaking, client performance update, which is really nice. Manta Style is super expensive. It's supposed to fix some of the low-end PCs having a problem with the client crashing, stuff like that. So that's nice. Nothing, no balance patches, though. The Afro Chick. My opinion on that matter is that, generally speaking, PA doesn't need a Manta. Your spells are not that important to cast generally, and usually PA is a BKB carrier anyway, so the question would then be, what are you trying to stop? You know what I mean? Normally Mantas throw off silences, slows, stuff like that. BKB does all of that, and it lasts, so there's really no reason to buy both a Manta and a BKB. I mean, it does give her some damage and attack speed, but usually there are better damage and attack speed items. She doesn't need the move speed because she blinks. The damage is kind of minimal. The attack speed's kind of meh. So usually there's a better item. The reason you buy Manta Style on other heroes is because either they have something that their illusions gain from. So Spectre has Desolate. AM has Mana Break. They carry Radiances. If you carry a Radiance, it helps. There's certainly a time where I could imagine that you could build a Manta Style on PA, but I really don't think it's generally the right option. There's usually a better option. Abyssal Blade. Abyssal Blade, Desolator, I'm trying to think, Scotty, Butterfly, depending who you're fighting, you could build an MKB. Maelstrom Recipe is actually really cheap. You have to buy your BKB, stuff like that is usually the better option. I could see it though, it's not the worst item, it's definitely not outside the realm of, realism, it just might not be the best. So, you got your balance there. I do believe, I don't remember, there was a balance patch in Dota a couple days ago. I don't remember if I talked about it. It was a slight troll nerf. I think I did. We talked about this. Yeah, okay. That's good. You've been seeing it a lot? That's strange. I really don't think it's great. It's good for pushing, I guess, since illusions do more damage now. A little bit, so it's a little bit better for helping you push, but usually damage is just better than that. It's not terrible. I could see it working in certain team comps, especially if you were using it for a certain reason. So, like, if they had Nature's Prophets, the tree man himself. Oh, no. I'll try to, offlane Timbersaw or something, because that's what I'm feeling right now. We'll see. If you were building it to, make Jug hit you less, because he's going to split between, that would be okay. If you were fighting a shadow demon who was using his damage amp AoE and you wanted to split, that would be okay. I can see a few examples where that might matter. I'm trying to think of anybody else who really has an ult or something that matters. If you want to trick somebody, I guess. Like, if there's a Necrophos on the other team, and you're like, oh, yeah, I really got to, avoid that Necro, and you want to, do a last-minute trick before you cast ult or something like that, I guess that would be alright. Little things. It's very bad against some heroes, though. Don't pick it against Axe. Don't pick it against, Earthshaker. Heroes like that. Oh no, a Legion. and they double down on the jungle. That's just life, I guess. Timbersaw is kind of okay. I'm worried about the Invoker. Good against Legion, just not so good against Invoker. I'm wondering who's better against Invoker that's off lane that can actually live. Phoenix is really bad because they're both going to hit me super fast. So I don't want to do that. Bristle would be okay, I guess. Bristle's really good right now, as we saw from the last gameplay Bristle, so I believe that could work. Alright, I believe it. He's gonna build a Silver Edge and I just have to accept it, but I'm, like, as we saw before, Silver Edge is more expensive, and still, Bristle is a force to be reckoned with. It's not like an immediate loss kind of counter, you know? I will be getting a Vanguard, almost certainly, so that'll be a thing. Because of the Vanguard aspect, I can't build any part of it, so I have to build something a little bit better with my items. I can go triple mango because of the reduced cost of mangoes in that patch from before. They cost 100 instead of 110. Normally I would be 80 gold left and couldn't buy a mango, but it's a great day. One extra HP regen and more mana when I need it. But I'm wondering if maybe it would be better to get a Basilius early, now that I'm thinking about it. Yeah, I've changed my mind. I need a Basilius badly. AM's carry now? What? I don't know what happened. I really don't know what happened. Yeah, I mean, I don't even understand. I'm glad he moved, though. He moved his... That Pudge has respect in my book. He moved. It was the right choice. He seems to have done it. All the respect in the world. That is how you play the game, you know what I mean? Even if there is no right reason why you should have to do what you do it anyway. We have the same tower because we have basically the same comparative level. Am I playing regular ranked instead of international ranked? I must be. Oops. It doesn't matter. If I lose, I'll be happier since I'm going to take the international rank score. I don't remember doing that. I swear I picked the international ranked, but I must have not been paying attention. I have zero spree, so there's no negative there. I don't think there's anything else I'd rather take as Bristle here. I actually might get a BKB in theory. I don't know if I will, but we'll see. I would always take Cool Spray. I know, right? No fight over mid is ridiculous. And I'm not gonna bother. Yeah, I'm still shocked. I swear I picked international ranked, but I don't know. Like, the Afro Chick, did you see me pick international ranked? Or am I out of my mind? Is AM coming bottom anyway? So we're gonna lose this game solely because I'm not gonna be able to farm. I'm not giving the AM space to farm. AM, you should mid, my man. You got the opportunity. Pudge will move for you. I have no slows besides this, which is not a slow I'm going to use in lane. Yeah, okay, you're right. That's fine. I don't blame you. I swear, though, that's what it was. I mean, even Void, he's strong against me early. I mean, I'll go harass if that's what I gotta do. The problem is Spiritbreaker has armor. Not gonna be able to do much to him, so that's fine. At least we got first blood. I mean, that's a positive. If all of us as individuals are good enough, then it should work out anyway, even though it shouldn't. Get myself some free experience here. I'll just go up with Slark, because his lane's much harder. I'm trying to bait him out into making the mistake of accidentally hitting me when my back's turned. I went to help my good friend Slark solely because he needs me. He needs my talents in lane. The only good thing about Faceless Void versus Bristleback is that when he jumps to take away my damage, he still has the stacks on him, so, you know, there's some positive. Small though it may be. So, I guess I'll get my treads next. I'm gonna have to. There's no other choice. Try to keep him low. I'm not too worried about him damaging me, to be honest. Bye, Spirit Breaker. It was worth it. I regret nothing. I don't know why I did that. And now I'll come with full mana. Basically, we're making the best of what I have. I'm 1-1-1, which is not so bad. We'll see. Taking his stats away is a very strong way to hurt Faceless Void. Slark still has a tango, so he'll be okay. For now. I'm just sitting here waiting for Void to show himself. I won't really be able to sneak because he'll see me from this angle, but at least he doesn't know I'm here already until he's already walking closer, so I might be able to catch him by surprise. We're getting tons of kills. It's very surprising, actually. He waited for the shrine. Tommy Spirit Breaker, wish he wasn't here. He didn't steal my bounty rune, unfortunately. I will live, but I will not live well, as they say. Better than nothing, I have boots now. I almost got a kill, but I knew I would die for it. Hey, what's up, Ricky Baby? I feel like I said that strange, but I think it might have been the name, not me. I've always felt weird saying baby, I don't know why. Term of endearment. Ooh, a Twitch Prime member too. Jealous. Oh no, Slark, I wanted that. Ah, the pain. I guess I have to go up here mid, but it's gonna be too late. This Shadow Fiend is getting money, unfortunately. I can't stop him, I don't have a slow. That's slow, my friends. And that's what I'm talking about. Teamwork. Basically, in this match, my role, we do have two people who are below me in the order of farm. So I don't have to buy support items, but I really can't be greedy with my build. Like, I can't go for an Octarine anytime soon. I have to go for some preserving, so I'm gonna go for my Power Treads, a Vanguard, maybe make that a Crimson Guard for my team. I know he doesn't have a Shrine to go to, so every bit of damage I do is worth it to me. He can keep hitting me if he wants. I mean, I'll be okay. He's already taking the damage, so can't do much. He does have Chrono, though, which scares me a little. Slark has level 6, almost 7. That should have been 7 for him. The deny didn't go through. I got the deny, but didn't get him the... Oh, crap. And then Slark is moving in. The lunatic. Invoker's coming to kill me. I don't know what the best play is here. I'm a little bit skeptical. A little worried. I don't have a lot of health or mana. Oh, you're getting charged. Okay. On my way. I ain't on my way. He stopped, thank goodness, because that would have probably ended in bad times for Slark. He does have ult under tower, which makes him very resistant to damage, but if more people come in, I mean... That's just what it is. Oh, nice again. We're getting so many kills. I cannot believe this game, which started so poorly in pick, has turned around. Best thing we can do now is just push this tower. And Slark can go in if he wants. I don't really have the ability to because I don't have much farm. I'm not diving tower for a potential of a kill, which might end up horrible. Slark actually has an escape. There we go. That was enough of a distraction for Slark to get away. He's going to be healing up super quick because that's that Slark life that I hate. I hate facing Slarks. It's so irritating. Not broken by any means, but it's just such an irritating mechanic to have to deal with when you're on the other team. Alright, now I'll finally get Treads 8 years later. Which also means I get a little bit more mana when I Tread switch. Very important for Bristleback. I didn't hear the Badum Tish. I guess I must have missed it. I see it, but I don't know why. I have no sound for it. I see an Invis Pudge, which tempts me to come over there, but in the same token, I don't have a ton of mana or health. So I'm tempted not to go over there. He will die. Okay, hook, so definitely dead. Do 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 do. Alright. Get some farm for the poor, poor Bristleback. This is going to be a denied tower. So worth. That's experience for me. The poor, poor Bristleback. Looks like that's a dead tree. Yeah, it's a dead tree. Sad to be tree in that situation, but what are you going to do? Oh, I need that badly. Now that I have the money, I can actually start regenning for real. Pushing the wave again, because nobody's here, obviously. Well, not obviously, but nobody's showing themselves here, so as Bristleback, it's kind of my job to, you know, push it in. You know, I'm pretty tanky. I'm not at much risk here. I could spam right now in order to get the extra damage from my war pack. I will, since there's creep waves around. That's a more efficient use of it. Because now I hit really hard. And that's money in the bank for me. Now, I gotta come help my team out here. It looks like it's going fine, but you never know. That went surprisingly super well. I cannot believe that just happened. I don't like how he keeps spamming the sound, to be honest with you. It always bothers me. And there is my wonderful mana regen that I've been waiting a while for. I've done enough damage to the tower. I'll go finish my Vanguard. I'll send myself some TPs as well. I can't go without them. People forget all the time. If you don't have a TP, you should have a TP. They're still on cooldown for now, so it's no negative, but soon enough, I'll need them. So I will ping that I'll get a Crimson Guard for our team. to help deal with the Shadow Fiend, Legion Commander, even Invoker, Faceless Void. They're all right clickers, basically. And then I'm thinking in this particular game, a Blade Mail is definitely the way to go, followed by Heaven's Halberd. Because stopping the right click from Legion, stopping the right click from Invoker, all of them, is very beneficial. Legion Commander's bot. We really need this mid tower, so let's get over there. I don't want to steal his last hit. That's not very nice. I don't need it that desperately. Oh, I thought I got that. That's a sad day for me. No biggie. It's just better when you have a hero take it because the bounty for... Oh, crap. The bounty for towers is actually kind of high. Oh, that's a dead invoker. That's easy. The only person who could possibly respond to this and not have an issue is me. Now there's more than one of us. We're going to have a good time. I'm trying to keep vision of the Shadow Fiend. I appreciated that sound. That was funnier. That was much funnier. Oh no, the tower. What are you gonna do? We gotta kill on a Shadow Fiend. It's way bigger. Just waiting for my level 2 ult. I'll start being much more helpful when I start getting bigger stacks. I mean, the damage per stack goes up by 5, 1% speed, percent, and then you get the max stacks increase, which is way big. Thanks to my Robe of the Magi, my mana regen and max mana went up. Which is actually quite significant. Because even though the total mana pool doesn't go up significantly, it does give me the spell imp, which for Bristleback is very important. Almost have my Blade Mail, so I'm pretty excited about that. I'm thinking that Blade Mail is probably going to be what stops Legion Commander from wanting to duel me. Legion Commander will also get a Blade Mail, but I'm going to do less damage physically, thus Legion will take the worst end of that bargain. He's got a Battle Fury. He's probably going to take my camp, to be honest. I am shocked. I am actually shocked. He is the first AM I've probably played with who didn't steal camps from me. This is great. Alrighty. We're getting close to my Blade Mail. It looks like Shadow Fiend is going to push this lane. I'm just going to be there ahead of time. Push it out so that he can't stay here. I don't want Shadow Fiend to feel comfortable. Alright, Blade Mail will be a thing once I get the chance to send it from the base. Right now, Pudge is using the courier, and I'm a polite man. I gotta finish my Crimson Guard, and then I will get my Heaven's Halberd. Alrighty, my turn for the courier, finally. I'm starting to actually come online as a carry now, kind of a semi-carry. It's taking some time, but you can always get there eventually. That's that Bristleback lifestyle. I would have stealing my courier, I want my Blade Mail. Alright, Send that stuff my way. While they're all distracted, I'll gladly help help take this. There we go. Move some stuff around for fun. Oh, what's up, JJ? It's been a while. As in, like, one or two streams. I want Void to know that I'm not- oh, crap. The hard counter. I was gonna buy out. I'm dead no matter what happens. Well, that'll help. That will not help. Come on, hit me faster from the back. No! Oh, that's a dead legion, though. Alright, worth. Yeah, not terribly long. It was, yeah, it was one stream, you're right. Well, welcome back. Currently, I'm a little confused. I don't even know if I'm doing international ranked right now. I swear I queued up for it, but, like... when we did the, you know, the battle pass levels, a lot of people had nothing for level. They had zero, you know, whatever, hyphen. Which makes me believe that, you know, I must not be in international ranked, which is fine, because I can just move that. Yeah, I know, they have all the disabled in the world. I'm not too worried about it. As I level up, I'll just be able to ignore it. You know, that's what Crystal Pack kind of does, but it takes time. This Pudge is very, accommodating. He has Scepter? Jeez. Greedy. I actually kind of feel like we're gonna win this game. It's not just the score that does it, though, because, like, Anti-Mage is actually getting stuff done. You know, I believe that we have a good shot at winning this. Alright, Heaven's Halberd coming in. Tank me up a little bit. How does Silver Edge counter me? It takes away Bristleback. Entirely. So, Silver Edge, to remind anybody else who's not aware, Silver Edge disables passives. That's the point. That's why you buy Silver Edge. It also does decrease the cooldown of your Shadow Blade, because it has a lower cooldown than Shadow Blade itself. But the main reason you're buying it is to disable cooldowns, and it reduces your damage. So your right-click damage goes down temporarily. The exact number I'm a little sketchy on, but when I end up seeing someone with one, I'll just click on it then, because it's easier. So, that means that I do not reduce any damage when they attack me from behind once I'm Silver Edged. For the duration of Silver Edge, of course. I didn't want to steal it, so I just walked away. I need to tank up, so that's what I'm doing. I'm not going to get an Axe this game, because yet again, it's not that kind of game. But that means I don't reduce any damage, and every time I take 210 damage, normally Bristleback throws out a free Quill Spray, basically. That's what he does. That's why you see him suddenly throw out like 18 Quill Sprays at once. You don't get to do that, because that's your passive, so it just goes away. That technically means you also don't get stacks of Warpath, I believe, but that's less important than the Bristleback. I don't have my blade mail on, so I'm gonna have a small problem here. Ugh! Come on! Armor! Move speed! Run, Bristleback! Oh, the anti-mage save. I can turn around. Since I'm Bristleback, I'll be okay. Can't avoid that. Oh, nice. So the reason that you buy a blade mail and bristle is if you know, despite your tankiness, that they're gonna hit you anyway. If they're not gonna hit you, there's no point. You know what I mean? Like, what's the goal? You know what I mean? Usually a blade mail is for when you know that they're gonna hit you no matter what. Like, they've already made the decision. You need to die. Now, I shouldn't be hit, but I know that they can't afford to avoid me because Shadow Fiend's squishy, Invoker is squishy, and Void's actually squishy as long as he's not time walking. They have to prevent me from starting to get stacks on them because they'll just explode. That's funny. Because of that, I gotta get the blade mail because it's gonna make their decision to kill me even worse, even though they've already committed to it. And it's, you know, the blade mail itself probably won't make them stop. And if it does, then job accomplished, because that means that they let me kill them, like I said. I mean, blade mail is always good on Bristleback, just because it gives you armor, intelligence, which you desperately need, and just a little bit of damage to go with the attack speed you get. Do you get attack speed anymore? You used to get attack speed. It's just more damage on top of the other damage you get. It's just a good item. It's a good item on most heroes, as long as you survive. Blade mail is more effective the more survivability you have, technically speaking. Because if you'll live long enough for the blade mail to take, like, 2,000 damage, then you're reflecting 2,000 damage. If you only have 800 health, then you're only getting 800 damage out of your blade mail. So it kind of, it scales that way. You only want to get a blade mail if you have the health to support it, and you're going to be hit. So if I'm a kind of hero that they want to lock down instead, so, like, if I was a lion, I'm not going to bother, because they're just going to see my blade mail pop and say, that's fine, just stun lion, we'll just wait. We'll handle him afterward, you know what I mean? There's no immediate need to kill him. So that's sort of the thing about it. And the Pudge is hilarious. He's really good, too. This Pudge knows what he's doing. I'm very impressed. What is wrong with the Slark? We're actually playing quite well. We have a lot of money. We have, I would say we have the XP advantage. There's my extra warpath. Now I'm fast. That's gonna be a thing. If they commit, I'll be there. I actually think I killed him off of, the hilarious blade mail into the ice wall, which is just silly because blade mail, ice wall does, like, no damage. It does do damage, but it doesn't do a lot. So the fact that that would be, the reflected of that would be what killed him is very funny to me. Looks like Sark's just trying to push the wave, which is very helpful. I don't mind tanking this. In fact, I'll just stand there, pointing the other way for a second. Awesome. We got their last tier 2 tower. We're in a great position to do whatever we want. We should probably go for Roche, since I can just stand there and tank for a year, since I went, you know, a tankier build, especially since I'm about to have evasion. Roche time. Come on. Oh, he's not there. Oh. I understand now. That's funny. I completely forgot. Even I make mistakes. So, other than that, I think the best way for me to matter here is to get, I don't even know, it doesn't even matter, actually. I might get, like, a Silver Edge. Just to, not Silver Edge, sorry, Sheba's Guard. just to increase my capabilities of... She's disarmed. I'm still dueled, so I had to walk back into that, so I might be a little screwed, but... Spell lifesteal is still the thing to do. Protecting my anti-mage. Alrighty. That was an easy fight in the long run. I mean, it started out poorly, but other than that, that was just a joke. The reason I might prefer Shivas is so I can keep them near my scary carries, basically. Just want to make it clear that I didn't ignore him. Sometimes cooldowns happen, you know? I'm going to push top lane because it's probably more effective. Yeah, BKB kills is my quest right now. I don't plan to buy a BKB. I was thinking about it originally. But since I'm not really a big carry, since I got pushed out of bot lane by anti-mage, it's not a great item. I'm never going to be able to afford it, and it'd be better than something else. So I'm just going to not bother. Well, they're distracted trying to kill anti-mage inside their airbase. They're about to lose everything they hold near and dear. And the great thing about being Bristleback is I can still attack this and damage all the creeps together. What's this guy think's gonna happen? Well played, Pudge, my man. Well played. So what, I would need 3,100? Well, guess what? I do not have it. I also did the math wrong. It was 27 plus 14, so it was 4,100. But I'm close. Now that I have the Mystic Staff, I bought that first because I need to cast more. I'm having a little problem with my mana staying up. Just a short while away from Shiva's Guard. They did increase the price by 50, but that's okay. No biggie. I am tempted just to buy BKB real quick, just to get my challenge, but like, it's not really... I'll buy it next. We're doing so well that I'll buy it next if the game's not over. Ooh, that's a very dead invoker. I lost a lot of my damage potential because I got time dilated, which is the worst. He has a BKB. Would you look at that? I set him up. That's why I bought the Heaven's Albert. This is an item a lot of supports should be playing. Should buying, I mean. It's a big deal. People don't buy it nearly enough for what it's worth. Now I'll just easily take these. I'll probably never afford that BKB, but you know, what are you gonna do? At least we're about to win. The reason I did the Crimson Guard is so that the creeps wouldn't die to, Oh, jeez. Dives. So that they wouldn't die to the towers there. Make this much faster. I'm not concerned with all the fighting they're doing over there. I just want to end this. GG. Well played. That's just the nice thing to do. So now we're going to find out if that was my... If that was regular ranked or international. See, they don't have battle passes, but I swear... I was wrong. No, I selected my regular. Well, it raised. My regular raised to 3,212, so I guess that's kind of cool. Alright, so now I will fix this and do international ranks like I was supposed to in the first place. No harm. Alright. Solo ranked. Fantastic. International ranked. There it is. Mana cost of ignite is 90. Yeah, too bad I couldn't answer that in time. Sad face. So that game, honestly, the reason we won is because they don't have the ability to kill me fast enough early. Shadowfiend doesn't have enough damage early, Legion doesn't early, Invoker can't afford to be casting on me because I can turn and he'll take a bunch of Quill Sprays. Spearbreaker can lock me down but not really kill me. And Void, him ulting me does nothing because they have a melee, and a caster. I mean, that's kind of meh. So they can't kill me. Slark is really strong because if he's ulting, Legion can't duel him. Shadowfiend can't do anything to him. He can try to raise, but it's not going to go well. Spirit Breaker can't do anything if he ults. Void still can't see him if he's in Chrono. So we just have really good... We have really good matchups, to be honest. Void's great against Invoker. And Anti-Mage is great against Invoker. Anti-Mage is great against Shadowfiend, because he can take the damage and just right-click him to death. He's good against Faceless, because he stops him from time-walking all the time. Pudge is great at catching Spirit Breaker, Invoker, good at pulling Legion off people, he kills Shadow Fiend. We just had great matchups. The problem was that we had horrible lanes, but I honestly just believe we were just better players. We were just better in most aspects. We just had better farm, better plays, like team fights and stuff. I had really low farm at the beginning of the game, but that's because I had to roam around a little bit. But there's not much to it. I'm not going to overanalyze it, because also... Also, the, I mean, it wasn't supposed to, it was regular ranked, which we're supposed to never play again until my new MMR takes over, but that was just a simple match. It was quick. It's just good matchups, good players. We also took good team fights. Pudge would pull people in, and because of that, we always had good initiations, which is very important. That has to be Void. I mean, Pudge must have had a ton of assists. Looking back, I'm sure he had most assists in the game. I had most assists in the game. Well, that's crazy. That's probably because Pudge got more kills, though. I mean, we just had a lot of assists besides Anti-Mage, who had all of the kills. We were all there. They split up. Shadowfiend was trying to split push a little bit on us, which did not work. Legion was farming too much, in my opinion. Legion wasn't there a lot. There weren't a lot of Blink duels, even though Legion has a Blink and bought a Blade Mail. Legion farmed really poorly. Invoker farmed horrible, bottom Midas, and that was a huge mistake. So we have, they are supposed to have good early game, because Shadowfiend's okay early game. Spirit Breaker and Legion at level 6 should be pretty strong compared to what we have ready for them, minus Pudge. But buying a Midas just kind of kills your early game, as I always say. And he didn't get it until 15 minutes, so it just ruined everything. He had no ability to do anything. I mean, we had two Midases, but our support bot won at 12, and... Our carry bot when it's at a little under 8. So, we just farmed so much better. Did my points just go down? Why would my points go down? I'm not supposed to get minus points for wrong answers. That's ridiculous. Ridiculous. This match is taking a while. I'm just happy that when I play international ranks, people might actually use their tokens. More. Definitely more. Feet are broken all the time. I'm hoping they fix most of them by this point. I hate that. I hate that. Come on. That's Bane? Doesn't sound like Bane, does it? I mean, it must, but it doesn't sound like what Bane sounds like. It sounds like water. Well, I guess I just don't play enough Bane or Morphling, which is true. I never play Bane or Morphling anymore. I used to play Morphling, but it's been a while. Six armor. That's not... No. It could be Bounty, because I don't think Slardar has that much armor. I think Bounty's slower than that. So I'm going to say Slardar solely because I think Bounty is slower. Ah! Every time. The move speed always kills me. I never know anybody's move speed in this whole game. I'm the worst. At least if my international rank tanks, I'll have a slightly higher solo MMR, so that's good. So I just won't take the new one. I'm almost done with my my 40 matches too, because we've been doing it together for a little while now. You know, 3 or 4 matches a day. So I must be. I think I only have a couple left. I'll check after this game, because I'd have to cancel the queue to check how many more I need to get to my 40. I'm also close to getting my last Battle Pass challenge for Q Time Trivia. That would be the friendly Sprout. Scary spell that it is. Sprout's incredibly powerful. Even sounds powerful. Twisting Roots. Sounds like Snowball too a little bit when people get in it, but that also makes a boop sound, so I knew it wasn't that. That wasn't a very good impersonation of Snowball, by the way. I admit that fully. Wow, 5 minutes. This is crazy. Come on. I don't know how fast Bane is. 310. Who knows? They're asking me these ridiculous questions I don't know the answer to. Trying to sabotage me. Ah, nice. Yes. First move speed question I've got right in a long time. There we go. Alright. I am prepared. Yeah, I don't know. They're not supposed to be. It depends on like your conduct too. I'm really not sure. I usually get really fast wait times, but not since this patch. Oh, no. Returning to matchmaking with high priority. My butt. Boots. I wonder which one they were. All right, come on. Don't fail me now, people. A 10th person. Have you guys ever heard about the Pyrian Flax comment on the 10th person of Dota? Because if you haven't, it's hilarious. If you even know who Pyrian Flax is, by the way. He makes game videos, Dota being, you know, used to be a big one. He used to make, I guess I'll go mid. He used to make, I don't know if he still does, but he used to make, like a how to play this hero in Dota. But they were always a joke, and he'd do the drawings himself. It was his drawings of heroes, so he'd just, like, show the drawing and, like, say things about them. And it was always really sarcastic and really negative. And he just, one of the times he talked about the fact that there's always one person who, you know, oh my god, that guy has way higher MMR. This MMR is way above me. It's 250 above me, roughly. Not too worried about it, but it's a little crazy. He just talks about that one person who always quits. Can't possibly be a real person, because how often could a real person start queuing for Dota then just change their mind and walk away? Or actively say no? So he hypothesized that 10th person is actually a demon, you know, in hell, that the job of that demon is to queue for Dota and then say no at the last second. And that's what they do all day to cause suffering to everybody who plays Dota. And I think that's a pretty good summation of what must be happening, because I just cannot believe that this many people queue up and then just don't accept the match. It'd be different if people queued up, joined the match, and then crashed. And then the match had to end due to connection problems. That's different, because at least you were there. You, like, you know, you attempted to. But, like, all the time, people just don't accept, and I don't understand. Once, back in when I first started Dota, I accidentally declined a match. And I was queuing with a friend of mine, and he didn't know what happened. And I was like, I may have hit the decline. And we had to wait the 5 minutes because of that. Puck's good against Necro, especially if I build a dig, and Puck's not so great against Lion because he can stop me. Great against Jug because I just go, no. So I'm feeling the Puck so far. And absolutely headcanon. That's what happens. Just believe it's a demon. I'll play Puck just because I don't want these people who haven't picked yet to feel, ooh, I'm good against Monkey King too. He can never hold me down. He's got nothing on me. All right, so the Puck build is, for me, almost always the same because this damage makes mid lane so good. Have to end up muting this guy because he's all, right from the beginning. Guys like, oh hey, let's you know, let's work together, not flame each other. Right from the beginning, we lost. Ugh. Absolutely. Well, also, I think that playing Dota, I do not want to have this challenge. Playing Dota is one of those things that people just like, they're asking for suffering, you know. So I like to believe that it must be the fact that. Okay, I don't think I'll get those kills, but it's just a good, it's a good try. It must just be that people think Dota players need to suffer, you know? We're the people who deserve it for choosing to play Dota. I'm also good against Bristleback because I can silence him and I can hold him down so he can't run away. So I actually feel this Puck game very strongly. The only problem is we don't have a good hard, we have no other carries on the team. Like, I had to build super carry Puck. Hopefully Nyx can matter. Nyx is good against Necro, because as soon as Necro goes, Nyx just goes. But we'll see if that actually happens, because. The problem with Dagon is I can use it against Necro. Good. You against Lion. Good. Jug. Oftentimes he'll be immune. Bristleback, awful, because if he turns around and I use it, I could get multiple quill sprays in the face instantly, just and I'll just die because I'm Puck. I'll just explode. And Monkey King, it depends if he builds health or not. If he does, bad. It's bad against him too. So I'm not sure if Dagon's the way to go. I'm trying to feel it out. At least we get cooler towers when we play international ranked because everybody has the battle pass. Good luck, have fun. I don't always take illusory orb, so I'm not sure if I'm going to. There are some heroes where taking an ability is, there's some abilities where you just want them. So Slark pounces almost always, correct. But there are times you probably want Essence Shift. So like Jug, Jug Spin. You want Jug Spin.
What am I saying? This is gonna be easy fucking game. Let's go.
Absolutely. Dagon counters Dagon, don't you know? Ridiculous.
Here's a word for you. Here's the tango for you.
I don't know if he's giving, who he's giving a ward and who he's giving a tango. Thanks.
What? What'd you say to me?
What?
They're all dead!
I need all of these. I'm gonna end up. I obviously don't make any money off of this, but like, you know, I make money because right I live with my parents, unfortunately, right now, temporarily. So I do have money. I just don't want to waste it on, that's Monkey King.
Oh boy.
He's just going to jump at the last second, but I'm going to take orb. I need orb. Here's the plan. Ready?
So wait, who are you last game down?
Get wrecked. Gets one hit off on me, gone. But I have money, I just don't want to waste it on the battle pass, but I'm going to end up dropping like $200 because I just need this stuff, it's so good.
It didn't work.
I just don't like...
My block wasn't great, but it's a little bit better than Necro's.
I understand, I get tilted as well. It's easier when I'm...
Necro cannot stand this, and I'm just going to keep hitting him if he stands there. Creep aggro was reduced anyway, the range they aggro, so...
So they blocked it.
I'm already 2-2 here. Last hits denies. Alright, I'll use my tango that I was so nicely given by that. I'm literally gonna do that. I'm gonna impulse buy so many of those. So I have to take phase shift next. If you're a Puck in the situation, please remember to take the phase shift, level 2. So that when Necro tries to death pulse you, you can just dodge. Like a pro. We are in a I'm already way ahead of him in denies and last sit, so that didn't help me. I don't need silence for Necro. It's really not going to be important. The only spell I care about is his Death Pulse, and I don't need to silence him. I just need to dodge it. Because him healing is less concerning than him dealing damage to me. I just jointed it. I think. Pretty sure I disjointed it. I did not disjoint that one. I know that. I'll have to use a fairy fire. There's no other safe method here. I can't afford to be risky with it. Goodbye. Not having that, I'll tell you that right now. I'll just go back to base and TP back. There's no reason for me to play risky. That was scary, but that's why you have to always be paying attention. I was already backing up anyway. As soon as you see him, throw him off. Phase shift instantly. It only lasts for 0.75 seconds, but he's probably going to try to stun you right off the bat. No reason to panic.
Monkey King's in our jungle.
Yeah, I just seen him. He's frozen through.
He's behind you now, Pug.
I have Illusory Orb, so as long as Monkey King doesn't line up like something crazy on me, I'll be fine. He's already running out of healing, this Necro. I guess not already. If it was already, he would have run out a long time ago, but I messed up and had to go back to base and all that jazz. I'll bottle even though I don't need mana. I just saw Rubick behind me, so I definitely don't want to waste Illusory Orb just to get last hits or to harass Necro. It's not worth it. Because dying will throw my farm off a lot more than missing a last hit or two. Early kill on Bristle is huge. I still should be ahead of Necro in farm. Though apparently I'm not ahead of him in experience, which shocks me. Because, really shocks me because I feel like I was significantly outdoing him, but I guess not so much. I'm not going to bother going for bounty runes because Monkey King will just get them. Alright, that was a very risky play, but, you know, it's probably going to work out in the long run. I got my boots. Damage the Necro a little bit, I'm going to make him waste a bunch of mana. He's not really getting that many stacks.
I think we could kill him, but you're able to land.
In the base? He's going for courier.
It's time, wait for me to freeze. Oh shit, here's Monkey King.
Oh boy. Got one hit off on him.
The line's missing,
dude. They're playing very aggressive, trying to get me or Crystal Maiden or anybody really.
I'm bringing my boots with this spark.
But the thing is, Monkey King can't really stand up to me in a prolonged situation. Wasted. He does have ult though. Want them to know that he has ult so that if he's coming in, that's a real threat. Lion is a DD, of course. I was right there.
Coming around.
I'm gonna need help with this Necro, honestly. I can't stay here forever. Trying to lower his HP down just so I can,
If you guys can land some shit.
Put him in a bad spot. So he doesn't want to stay here. Of course, he got an infused raindrop.
Anyone can come their way, bottom.
Alright, Slark is about to be sick, so we'll come down.
No thanks. That's bad.
I'm walking, so it's gonna be me.
But Zerk has zombies left.
Oh my gosh. Very well.
I can't go any further than that. Has ult. Don't wanna die to it. That's when players make the mistake.
All right.
There's a difference between harassing and dying.
Oh, shit.
Oh, no. I'm dead. That would be the dying.
Why is this still open?
That's so terrible. I am so irritated. Of course he was invis. Why not get an invis, right? I want to come top and help out. I was doing so much better than Necro, and I don't know how he kept up in levels. I denied way more in the early time. Just take the farm once here, right? I'll have my mana boots in a second, so I'll have a better capability to harass. I haven't taken my silence yet, because it wouldn't help.
Nice job. I'm here. Let's turn a bright line. Yeah, you're good, though.
I'm just going to throw my orbs at Jug. And the creep wave. Got Jug in that. Now I'll get silence. Next is my blink dagger, because I need to be able to get in there.
Oh, damn. 5 seconds for a
just trying to stop this Jug from free farming. It's not really working, but it's better than nothing. It could take me forever to get up here, but no bristleback casting here.
Man, this bristleback is just fucking rough.
No thanks.
How does he have so much mana?
He does have a lot of mana. His magic wand is doing work. But I lived. I got 2 kills, right? Yep, 2 kills. Speed up my regen by using bottle and fountain. Always use your bottle and fountain when you're regenning. There's no reason not to. Get some money up in here because I need my blink dagger fast so I can go in and out. Makes farming the creep wave easier too. Oh crud. I'll phase shift if things go wrong. I don't mind. He will eat away at my health real fast, though, so I have to be quick. The panic on Slark. Oh, my. It's not going well so far. The score is relatively even, but it's not going well with us missing all three of our towers and us only having one.
Oh my god.
Try to keep some of them held down, but it obviously didn't matter.
To start mana draining this fucking first place.
Oh no.
Oh, hit him one.
No thanks. Maybe some other time. Ooh, that's that puck life. It's a second death I've avoided with, at the last minute with Bristle involved. Oh no. Oh. That was not good.
My bad, boys.
I'm close to my blink dagger, sort of. Alright, now I get my 8 intelligence. Cast more, do more damage. All that good stuff. I just need more money. Until I get a blink dagger, I'm not really able to participate in parts of these fights. Like last time, I would have killed Necro. When he had that, you know, almost no health thing going on. He does, unfortunately, have a hood. I want to fight somebody here, but it's very difficult to get someone who's actually able to be killed by me. Healing ward on Rubik, that's nice.
Watch. Oh yeah, I'm super triggered, I think.
Just trying to make sure that I can get something going here. I'm getting really close to Blink Dagger, so I don't want to die. So I don't want to, like... I don't want to use my orb to farm, but I have to. Keep Crystal Maiden nice and manned up. That way, if things go wrong, I'll have her assistance. Alright, this is just a harass juggle. Jug spawns, so that won't really work, but. I need to get down there.
What? Oh, get by that?
Get him. Go online.
Go.
I'm coming, because if I show up, it might actually make a difference.
Okay, I'll be slashed. Yep.
Dang, dang, dang.
Why are they all so fast? I actually have to get
faster. Creep block.
I don't have a high enough. Oh. Well, goodbye. I say I don't have a high enough level of phase shift to get my blink dagger off. You need level 4 for that. With guarantee. Okay, he wasn't silenced, I guess, for very long at all.
No omni slash on that guy.
I got Jug first, it was worth. That was so worth. I'll take it. Very important right now that I stop the people who are the big farmers, you know? Rubik's gotta take Quill Spray, I think. It's good. And it's hard for him to stay around enough to use it, but it's pretty decent. I guess Blade Fury is not bad either, but it does silence him when he uses it. Doesn't mute him, though. So, you know, you got your trade-off. I'm actually gonna take Phase Shift next so that I can TP easier and blink easier in middle of fights, because that's gonna be one of my biggest problems. That was blue.
I think that was a monkey can I just saw right there. You just pounced on a tree. Alright, see on me? Yes.
Ah, oh, fuck that.
He critted, dude. What the hell?
Not worried about Monkey King, though I do see him.
I'm on the case.
Honestly, I have this wave to push while we're fighting bottom. That's something useful I can do while moving. We really need to get out here.
I'm busted. I have Shadow Blade on the way.
Shadow Blade's nice. Is that Slark Shadow Blade? Yeah.
Did anyone... Oh, shit. Monkey King's right here.
Go online.
Can we jump this back?
I don't have Dream Coil, I don't have anything for him. Not really.
What is that crit chance, man? Holy shit.
Gotta build something that's useful, and this is the best I can get right now. Well, is that coming Radiance on Necro? Because that'll be a small problem for me. He's got a Mana Style throw off silences, which will lower his carrying potential but increase his survivability.
Yeah.
Oh no. Well, it was worth it anyway. Really tried there. Nyx is gonna die. Probably. Oh no, he has a Carapace now. Ooh. Oh my god, if we can get both these guys, that would be huge. Necro has to be first, always.
Hit the shrine, Oh my god.
Nicely done indeed.
They're trying to throw.
I don't know about trying to throw, but...
Yeah, for sure, dude.
I'm pretty sure I saw like five of them.
All right, let's get some stuff rolling. We gotta push.
Oh, look at them. They want some. That's right. They're hunting. Just take it, take it.
And debate them in.
Nice, that's a big one. You have a finger too?
Lion's one of the more dangerous people to me, so.
What? I'm real close to silver now.
Jumper is up here. I don't know. I'll go look for the Necro, maybe. That was such a huge fight for us.
They basically, like, all four heroes died. I have no idea what they do.
I'll let it be for now. After them. I don't want to mess around with the Necro too much. He's just scary. With his radiance and everything. His ult.
On the cage, I see him.
Magic resistance. It's not amazing here, but it's pretty good.
Let's take this down.
I think I need to go carry, though. If I'm getting hit with magic, I'm dying anyway. It seems a little crazy, because I know I need to survive, but like...
Okay, I'll just... Oh, it's already gone.
No, he's gonna, like, not even take it. Right, maybe he is.
The Hadouken. Oh, thanks.
Nice, that's big.
No, I was just hitting my thingy. No. And it's nice that we got such a big take, but nice. I'm very sad that I had to die for that.
I like to see.
At least I got my Dagon off before I died.
I don't have a TB, but it's fine.
Need to push. He's broke. This Monkey King is very broke. After I get my Dagon, I'll get an Aether Lens. I'll turn this into Aether Lens. I'm not doing it yet because, I need the mana boots, but once I'm a higher level, I'll have better ints and all that jazz, so I won't need it as much. Aether Lens gives you mana regen now too, but it's nice to have the burst mana for my team. There'll be a point that comes when it's really not as important.
I would just get Echo Saber.
I'm attacking very hard right now, which I really like. It's very helpful.
Or if you think you need mana, Orchid.
Orchid would be good.
I'm gonna end up with an Orchid.
Bloodthorn is like the best option.
Well, I'm behind them. Me and what's his face are behind them. Nice la.
I love Dagon. So good.
There's a regen.
I can go Orchid. I think an Orchid would help a lot. I think after my Aether Lens, I'll go Orchid. Now I push towers a lot better. It's one of the reasons I took the damage. We really need to take these towers.
Don't get overconfident like they did. Back up. This is a good time to back up.
I don't know what I can do to help here. I'm trying to look. See if anybody's within, like, killing range. I'm still alive right now, so... We can potentially rebuff their push. It's a little bit rough, though. Wait till I get the extra spell amp from the int from the extra Dagon. Puck's a decent
counter
pusher.
They might plan for Roshan or something.
I think an Eighth Lens is good now, actually. Before I finish the rest of my stuff.
We're gonna smoke to their jungle and try to pick up orange.
Let's do it.
What are you doing, man?
Alrighty.
Oh my god.
Just
pop the smoke.
They have no ward on road. Oh, they do have a ward on.
We should be going for this necro.
They're all in the jungle, actually.
I will repeat the statement, they are all in the jungle. That's why we don't want to be there. Whole time I was against this necro. And they better take everybody else. They're doing good so far. Slark might be able to take the Bristleback, it's iffy. Octarine Core, no, definitely not. Silver Edge, okay, he's safe. I'm just dying because they're really focusing me.
Rubik, can you play with the team next time?
It's poor Crystal Maiden. Okay, she's good. She's good. No worries, everyone. She's got it.
I'm like so close to my egg. Let me just get egg.
Eggs isn't bad. It holds them down, so there is definitely benefit to it. One of the problems we're having is we're just getting so many of us. We're having a big fight, and then whoever's on the side, some of us die. Like me, I'll die, or like, you know, Crystal Maiden get picked off. And then, you know, the other person will join the fight on the other team, and then we don't do as well as we could. I'm actually gonna walk.
To this necro.
And I'm walking mostly because I don't want to waste my TP. I want to keep it ready.
There's the order.
I am at level 3 ult.
Go through the mid.
Lower cooldown, more right damage. In. The stun is longer if they break it.
That courier is going to reveal us.
Oh. My bad.
My assumption.
Pulls up here.
That's what.
Ah. No thanks. I don't want to be digging during that.
Good job, boy.
Picking up. I pushed
over because Deadpool.
Very good. If things go bad, I have a TP. That's why it's nice to come prepared.
I not think that would kill all of them.
I have vision. Unless that's power vision.
You need to drop the Dagon and fucking, or I mean, don't drop it, but stop upgrading and get eggs, man.
Oh, Nick, sniping at me. I was like, me get eggs. I don't see the benefit. They're not building PKBs yet. Ooh, that money.
We can push for that. He is TP.
We can fight the jug.
No, I'm dead. Yet again, they just cannot leave me alone.
Yeah. I have ult in 4 seconds. Ult right here.
I had already blown everything anyway. Steal it. Oh, his thing is cooldown. Never mind. I was yelling at Rude for no reason. His thing's on cooldown.
Oh, what are the cooldowns? No left? Oh, it's on. Damn.
We got this.
You can do this.
Yeah, I'm willing to push.
Which should be enough, because what's going to happen is creeps spawn now, and now they're in tower range.
I could be fast.
Which gives them a significant advantage, because there's 152. 142 and 162, that is. So even though these creeps, there's less of them, they have a huge artillery strike behind them.
Oh boy.
So they'll hit the tower a couple times. Just the 4 range creeps now.
Yeah. Nice.
I guess you can go back, no big deal. I really don't understand why we didn't really take this. Killing me. There we go. Okie dokie. I have an Aether Lens, which is going to make me a little bit more survivable and a little bit more damage, because of the damage amp on it. Also some mana regen, which is nice. I'll be selling the bottle as soon as it gets me something else.
I'll take that haste and let's go back bottom.
Oops. Hand was misplaced in the keyboard. I'm sorry, friends. I failed you. I think of all these items that could benefit me right now, and it's killing me. Like, you know, I want an orchid. I want to finish my, you know, Dagon. I want to get it bigger. All this stuff.
Yeah.
I just don't have any money.
Yeah, let's go on next.
Oh, I can solo him? What? Oh, fuck.
Now it's worth coming over. Just for the cleanup. Oh, I missed him. It's okay. I'm gonna check this rune, see if it's anything important before we go, like a DD. Nothing. It's bottom, not worth me going down there right now. So we should be able to take this tower and hopefully rotate and take top. We could try to push this in, but probably not gonna work.
We get the tier 1 top.
Oh shit, I haven't touched top.
Yeah,
yeah, let's do that.
Yeah, I just don't wanna get... High ground seems scary. Like after top, if they don't respond, they can like rail shoot real quick. So by the time Solar Crest...
Ooh, alright. We got another tower. We did just give them back a fortify, though. It has to be noted.
I'm coming top. Let's go for tier 2.
Oh. More range on my Dagon, more damage. That was a very poor start. Look at Vision for CM. And Slark. If I could save him, I would. I can't. Nothing I can do for him. Very sad.
Where? Oh my god! No way!
Christ.
I cannot believe he just killed a bunch of them.
Oh my god. More, I think he would have gotten bristle.
Yeah. Although he was healed from quills.
And that's all the money I ever need.
Yeah, I don't think he just saved us a rock.
That's huge. I cannot believe he got all that. He just completely rebuffed them by himself. Alright, Orchid's next. Now my Dagon range is really, really far. More damage, all the good stuff. I was hoping to get Lion, but he's not around. Very sad. Just trying to get as much money as I can really fast so I can start into this Orchid. Because they're all up anyway, you know what I mean? Dang, Monkey King with his gem. I can see most of them near their base, so I feel pretty comfortable farming this. My problem I'm having is my health regen is kind of crap, but what are you going to do, right? You're a puck. There's not many items you could build that would help in that case. I mean, if I built like a Lincoln Sphere, I'd get some HP regen, but it's not worth it.
If I have my upgraded eggs and it applies Frostbite, then I level the Frostbite talent tree. Does that apply?
Probably, yeah.
Okay.
My second half is pretty fucking
awesome. It's huge. That combination is crazy. Crystal Maiden Ags with the increased Frostbite duration. Not fun. Yeah, I mean, I could definitely go Lincoln's. The only problem I have with it is that it could be popped so easy. All Bristle has to do is just sneeze at me. It would be a great item if it weren't for Bristle, because then I'd be blocking either Necrol, Lion Ult, or Hex. All of which are great to block, you know?
The Bristle box is crazy.
Here I go. Bye, Lion. Finally, vengeance on Lion.
No, they have a jump, by the way.
Oh, okay.
We need to kill that Monkey King to get that jump. It's a high priority.
No thanks. No thank you.
Do you need a buyback?
I don't have buyback.
I just want to scare Jug. Make him remember why, you know, Necro is killing me every battle. Can't finish him off. My silence won't kill him. It was worth. It was so worth. It's true. I might get it after my Orchid, in theory, because I really do need to regen in between battles, otherwise I can't keep pushing. You know, 3.6 is not enough, and I don't think anybody's carrying a mech. No. There's no Vlads either, I don't think, so I might. It would certainly help. Because if they try to get me with that ult, I'll be so happy to have it blocked.
Okay.
And by the way, what's up, GT Mando? As I have not seen you here before. Welcome. Hopefully my Orchid's done soon, because I need... I am so poor. I know Dagon 5 is expensive, but I still feel very poor. Although that Dagon 5 has paid off with the weakening the Jug and killing Necro just like that. And Lion. It's worth it solely for the Necro-Lion issue. If they're ever at 60% health or lower, dead. Cooldown's so low, too. Oh, of course. Hey, that's what this is here for. Input. You know, everybody's welcome to their own opinion. And I always take it into consideration. I am not perfect, by any means. If I was, I wouldn't be 3.3k MMR. I would be, you know, 8, 9. I think that's the max right now, right? People have hit as 9, 9 something. Unfortunately, I can't even go over there. I gotta stop this. Push! Well, now I gotta counter push that.
Got some stacks back.
I'll lead it. I led too far, unfortunately. I thought that was them for a second, and I was like, what? They stole our Roche? I am very happy to realize I was mistaken. Late game money when these creep waves are huge is so good. Ugh. I love it. Alright, I almost have my Orchid. I feel like their team's gonna come for me soon because I'm pushing, but I'm relatively escapable. So unless there's too many of them, it won't be a problem. Yeah, I'll get a Lincoln's. I am planning bots this game. I want them really bad. They just feel less important than the other items, but that's what I'm gonna do. I had the Arcanes earlier. I don't know when you started watching, but I had Arcanes, which I turned into my Aetherlens, and I need my boots of travel, but I don't want to die, because me showing up to die is not helpful. I think after my Lincolns, I'll probably get boots of travel to free up an inventory space, because otherwise I'll have these two and the Orchid will be there, and where does my Lincolns go? So I'll move the TP out. Lincoln's boots of travel. I'm waiting for level 25 so I can get my illusory orb distance. Because I'm glad you agree, by the way. Glad we're on the same mindset. I really need it because I need to get out of there. The problem is right now is that even when I do illusory orb, they can catch up to me because of the incredible move speed and monkey jump. Right, this is going to really blow Lion up, by the way, because the damage amp afterwards. That wasn't good. I needed to get in there faster. Alright, if Slark's out, if Crystal Maiden's out and everybody else is out, might as well be out. We lost the Aegis, which is unfortunate. We did get a tower, though. Crystal Maiden's 25, jeez. From those solo team fights, she's really gained. I'm getting close to that level 25. One of the main problems they're going to have with Crystal Maiden is that if Lion's dead, they have a hard time stopping her from ulting. Like a really hard time. Their only way to stop, other than Lion, is a Necro ult or the Monkey King stun. And the reason he has the stun is for damage, not really the stun. He doesn't want to waste it if he can avoid it. I don't know how I missed that. I knew who it was. Oh, Necro has BKB. Scary. Did not know that. Never came up. Ow. That hurt. Trying to poke at him, but it's a painful process. Doesn't get rid of that. It's getting out. No reason for me to die here. Sneak back in a second. Hopefully kill whoever I can, basically. Monkey King, in this case, is my goal. He's not very tanky. Best I could do there. Too scary. Too spooky. I need Perseverance now, otherwise I'm never going to have the regen. We're able to rebuff them to a reasonable degree, but it's not easy. It's always a struggle that risks death for all of us.
Fuck, man.
All this money is beautiful.
Like, Monkey King is not doing anything until I...
As expected, Monkey King is saving ult for Crystal Maiden. Doesn't want to, but he has to. What are you gonna do, you know, let Crystal Maiden ruin your team? So close. I'm one of the last people, right? I'm ahead of Nyx and Rubick. That's true, actually. Really use
like,
a BKB. I'm dead. No buyback. Gotta play it safe. This might be the end of this match, and I'll be very sad. I really don't want this. I just hit 25 too, so I actually did longer because of the fact that I hit 25 right at the end. That was quick.
Are you kidding me?
Slark's dead. This is GG. Almost certainly. Everyone's dead, so it has to be. You missed Nyx dying and me dying near Nyx trying to help him. I ulted and then they immediately jumped in. And then because of that, they steamrolled into Slark and Crystal Maiden and Rubick, and that's the problem. Oh well, what are you gonna do, right? I know he's dead forever. It's because he bought back before. He was already level 25 and had a long respawn cooldown before that. Unfortunately, we just didn't have enough late game. That's what it comes down to. Our late game is kind of, besides Slark, is not good. Yeah, I think so too. I don't think I've seen someone longer, dead longer than a minute 60. 160, I mean. That's really long. Alright, before I go over the last match, I will just queue up real quick. So, minus 21. That's like the lowest I've ever lost, actually, so I'm pretty happy with that. Let us see. Fuck. Well, my net worth was the highest on the team, which actually surprises me. I feel like I was had less money for a little while against the CM, but I guess I surpassed them. I was about neck and neck with Necro, being outdone by Bristle and Juggernaut. The problem was is that Juggernaut got a lot of money early. Buyback did kill it. That's true, actually. I never bought back, so that's true. We can actually see. Let's take a look at the player net worth and how it was maintaining. So Crystal Maiden, actually relatively consistent. Slark hit a big drop at the end, so he actually was up there with them. I'll count the fact that Slark was up there with them. Rubick and Nyx were relatively poor. I was consistent. One of the biggest problems is that the end game, they start getting the BKB gem, Abyssal Blade, Blade Mail, another a Skull Basher on Monkey King, which is really bad now, by the way. Nobody should buy that, but still. Necro finally got his ag so he could ult all the time. We just can't keep up with it. They have so many carries. I mean, we had such a good advantage, but we didn't push as hard as we should have, which I said at the time. I said we need to push harder. But since it didn't happen, we just kind of fell off. Most of the damage in the team was split between Crystal Maiden, me, and Slark. Nyx wasn't too far behind, actually. I'm not surprised by that. I mean, I had a Dagon 5, so of course a lot of the damage was me. Realistically, it breaks down to the fact that we didn't have any late-game carries. It's me and Slark. It's Slark, actually. I'm not even a late-game carry. Slark, kind of me, kind of Nyx, versus Jug, Monkey King, Bristleback. Even a little bit Necrophos is better than some of us for late-game. And that's what just was guaranteed to happen if we didn't push hard enough, and we didn't. There's not a lot of complex reasons why that happened, but that's what it is. So I'm going to try to safe lane here so I don't have to deal with that again, because that always irks me. How do I deal with a TA? Well, one way to deal with TA is damage reflection and damage over time. So I think that will be the best way I can really face her. What kind of challenges do I have available? Unfortunately, I have to use the Rising Tide a lot, and I really don't like to, because, you know, it's kind of hard to get some of these done. I don't usually like to build BKB on Spectre, because if you're building a BKB on Spectre, you're killing your late-game potential for damage. Health is usually better, because she's reflecting damage anyway. Because, Dispersion is great. Amazing ability. We're not in captain's mode. I think that killing towers could happen. Especially if we have a Jakiro. We have a chance at that one. That's a fair one. Spectre is good against Bristle because all the damage he deals to me reflects back anyway. Yeah, I mean, I've built a BKB on like Anti-Mage even though I hate that too. On Spectre, I've almost never done it, but it could come up. If they had, like, a Lion, if I got Spectre and then they immediately built Lion, Shadow Shaman, you know, people like that, yeah, I'd have to buy one. So, it looks like the average MMR is much lower this time. Last time I was a little bit out of my league. But this time I think we have a much better chance. So, I'm good against, all of them except Omni. Omni's really painful for me. But it's better than the Anti-Mage I was thinking about picking. Well, actually, Anti-Mage is really good against Bristleback. I don't know. I'm kind of struggling. I think I'm going to stick with the Spectre. Because they can hold them down anyway. I believe that picking the Spectre is going to end up more beneficial to me because they're going to hold him down for me. I could always get a Diffusal, that's true. Probably not right away, I want my Radiance first, but a Diffusal would not be a bad item, because it'll ruin Bristle, it'll ruin Omni. It doesn't get rid of Repel anymore, but it still makes it so you can't cast. You're not a Spectre player at all? No, but it's true, though. A Diffusal Blade is probably a good pickup here. Instead of going for Mantis Style, after my... lose my train of thought. Instead of going Mantis Style for after my Radiance right away, I should probably get a Diffusal. I can actually get it before Radiance, but it depends how well I'm farming. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. I definitely want a Vanguard, because I need to tank up right off the bat. I mean, I always buy a Vanguard almost, but I think it's the right option here, because, you know, with a TA going to try to right-click me, Bristle's going to try to chase me down, and that gives me bulk HP, which I need desperately.
Hey, guys.
Shadow Fiend's going to right-click me, Jug's going to right-click me.
Thank you.
Alright, now this is on the line now. Someone just bet 1,000 tokens for us all. Now we have to do this. For them. I don't even know who did it. Is it Tell? No. And if you're not a Spectre player, then you're about to learn, my friend. I know this is your first time to the channel, but basically what I try to do is I'm of course trying to win, number one. You know, that's mostly the priority because, you know, that's the goal of Dota. But aside from that, I like to, you know, make sure that I can teach people something about item builds, about hero matchups. And even when I lose, I like to point out why. Why did we lose? Oftentimes it goes down to picks, but even some plays. Like, one of the reasons we lost last game also was because I went out with Nyx, and we were both caught out. We might have been able to rebuff them if we didn't do that, but that was a huge loss. You know, I like to teach people something, ideally anyway. I might not always have something I can teach a player, but if they can just get one glimmer of information, then it's all worth it. That is totally accurate. If Jug gets farm, it's not really Abaddon's fault. He's not really going to, you know, be able to do much to him. Fact. If I free farm, we win. I love it. The Afro chick will back me up. Every time I free farm to Spectre, I've pretty much won the game. Yeah, I would not do a 1k bet unless I was playing with four friends I know. That's just too much. You know, I'll bet my 250. I'll do a 250 token on top of it. I will not do 1,000. And I'll remind everybody, the reason I usually go these items is because Spec can't afford to be pushed out of lane, so a Stout Shield is kind of mandatory. Just in case you take creep aggro, and just in case they try to push you out. And the Quelling Blade isn't mandatory because Spectre has crap base damage. Like, it's actually really bad. As far as the tank goes in Fairy Fire, I just find it the safest option for long-term survivability. But you could probably go for, like, a Mango instead of, you could probably go for, like, Tangos and Clarities or something if you really want to be more aggressive. Because right now, if Bristle came too far forward, I could throw a Dagger. Now, I don't want to do that because then I won't have Dagger forever. But it would definitely be an option. I'm going to do, for the first time, my treads before my Vanguard, and the reason why is because I feel entirely confident that I'm safe in this lane. There's very little they can do about me, because we're a tri-lane. Because of that, I need to farm better. Like, make sure I'm not missing last hits, like that one I just missed right there. And because of that... Oh my god. Because of that, I want to make it easier. So, like, if I had treads there, I probably wouldn't have missed those last hits, honestly. Like, under tower, it's always rough, but you have to do everything in your power to prevent missing any last hits of your carry. Also, the Vanguard's a little bit less important in lane, because Bristleback isn't going to right-click me as much. He's going to Quill Spray me. And the shield does not block Quill Spray at all. Alright, two hits, and then I can get this. Yes. The tower does have a 20 damage range, but you can pretty accurately guess. It is physical, but damage block doesn't usually block physical. It only blocks actual right clicks. So there's a difference. It seems ridiculous, but it's true. So my Stout Shield will block Bristle if he attacks me. It'll block a creep if he attacks me. But if he casts Quill Spray, it doesn't do anything. My armor will still prevent it, because it's still physical, so armor still applies, but armor is different than damage block. They're two separate things. It's really annoying, actually. Gotta get that experience. Ugh. Well, all this free experience, I love it. Alright, they're not gonna kill any creeps under their tower, so I will quickly buy Gloves of Haste to make last setting a little bit better. There are a few physical abilities out there that get blocked by damage block, but they've been trying to remove them. I don't remember which ones are left, but the game has been actively trying to remove that function for a while. They're also trying to remove UAMs for the same reason, that it's a silly mechanic. Unique attack modifiers are just dumb. I understand why they used to exist for balance, so that you couldn't stack lifesteal and armor shred and the incredible slow of Scotty, but it's just not a thing anymore. Yeah, I do too sometimes. It is often the right choice. The reason I didn't go for it this game is because I wanted the gloves anyway, because Spectre's attack isn't super fast. So I wanted to speed it up versus damage. But it's definitely not bad to go for the Agi first. Sometimes I go for the strength first on Agi heroes to survive, like if I'm getting heavily harassed. That Bristle has no idea what I do. 20 pure damage per attack, reflect 14% back on Bristle. That was not bright on his part. A big part of Dota is knowing exactly how far you can go without dying. Like, I knew that was going to be risky, but that's why I carry a Fairy Fire. I right-click him a few times, get the bonus of Fairy Fire, and then I eat it. Get that 75 burst health, which he's not expecting if he wasn't looking at my items. And it's done. He's an early level Bristleback, so he doesn't have a lot of damage with Quill Spray anyway. Yeah, that Bristleback must be really angry. Because he probably thought he had me, too. He probably thought he had me and Jakiro, that one of us would escape and the other one would die. But he was a little bit too confident for Bristle. Bristleback's hard, just like Axe, to know exactly when you can and can't go in. But you learn. I don't think I can possibly get this, but... ooh, yes. So satisfying. I'm getting very, very fed right now. I'm going to grab the Vitality Booster first, because it's more expensive. I'm also going to Tango right now, so that when I buy the Vitality Booster in a couple seconds, it'll give me a better percentage of the total. Whole trend switching kind of idea there. Oh, and I don't know about you guys, but if you don't have it on, you guys should definitely change the function that lets you have the ability like rangefinders on. As you can see, I can cast Dagger really far. And Alt to see tower range. It's a big deal. Very much helps. This Bristleback does have a ring of health. I mean, I'm just gonna leave. Like, I'm fine. I certainly didn't expect him, but like, eh. I'll just leave, you know what? Why bother? It's not default anymore, I don't think. It might be on by default, but I don't remember. But it's just either way, if it's not on, turn it on. This is very helpful to see the range of things. As far as getting stuck with unfamiliar heroes is nice as long as you're not playing ranked. I like to be familiar with every hero in the game. So personally, what I did when I first started playing Dota is in bot games, I would just pick a new hero every game. And if I didn't understand them, I'd play them again. Like if it just didn't make any sense to me. And throughout my, you know, however many hours I've played now, 2,500 hours... I feel I have a good grasp of every hero in the game. Like, I could probably, maybe not by name, but I could probably tell you what, if you named a hero, I could tell you all four of their abilities. And what they do, basically. I might have no numbers, but I could tell you what they do. Because I've played every hero enough that it's like, yeah, I know what all these heroes do, you know what I mean? And it's a huge asset. Aw, crap. Nice. Missing Bristleback, I wonder where he is. Getting myself some free XP. Strength shred switch because I'm about to get hit by the tower. It minimizes the damage done because my health pool is bigger, thus the percentage changes. Always a big factor. Look at this Bristleback. What do you think he's doing? I'll back up for a second. Hey, nice, man. Respect for that. I'm at 2,738, so I'm not far ahead of you. Yeah, it's definitely, I'm definitely going to go for Radiance, by the way, because they're allowing me to just farm it. Like, they're not stopping me. Now, we both have a Vanguard. And unfortunately, his Vanguard is worth more, because I right-click more than he does. Which sucks. I love to watch, like, videos on how to play Dota and other people play Dota, because I feel like you can learn a lot from other people's perspectives. You'd be like, oh, I never thought about it like that before, you know? That's also why I like having you guys around watching me, because you have your own inputs about what items I should buy. And everybody's input is helpful. I'd love to ult over there, but he's currently magic immune, which means I won't be able to, I won't be able to dagger him, so I'm not gonna get a kill. Unfortunate. Oh, nice, he let me get both of them. Looks like Omnite's coming over. I can just farm the jungle if I really want to. Now that I have the Vanguard, my treads, it's not very hard. I see Omni, but... doesn't do any damage to me. Like, I know he thinks he does, but he really doesn't. Probably should have done it earlier. Chikira was pinging, and I should have been paying attention. But I got another level. More Desolate. Faster farming. I didn't die, so, you know. It's not like anything bad happened. I'm just tempted to eat it, to eat his Tome of Knowledge. I know I shouldn't, so I won't, but... Alright, their ward's gone. That's good. So it's Omnite and Bristleback, which means I really can't kill Bristleback. There's nothing I can do about him. Okay, so you max Dispersion first. And I probably didn't need you this game, to be honest. But you max Dispersion first so that you cannot be pushed out of lane. It's such a strong ability. It gets you kills. It stops them from getting kills. Because it makes you take less damage. I, like, you literally take less damage overall. which most abilities don't do that. Like, Blade Mail reflects it, but you still take 100% of the damage. You actually take 22% less damage, just flat. Which means that I can afford to tank creeps. I actually get less hits from creeps sometimes, too. And especially against melee carries, if I end up tanking the creep wave, they're taking that damage. They're taking 22% of it. And he did want that last hit, he's greedy. And it really makes a difference, you know? The good thing is Bristle's running out of mana. I'm not running out of anything. I regen very quickly. The Bristle back does not concern me. It does hurt the gank potential. But as a position 1 Spectre, I feel like people try to gank too early in lower level games. So amongst the pros, they always have that careful, good team play that'll get you early kills. But in these kinds of games, you really can't expect to get a kill. People get too greedy. They say, oh, I'm level 6 as Spectre, I should be able to kill. And it's like, well, realistically, you're probably going to do better for yourself to farm. You know, like at my MMR, which is right now 3,300, I'm going to do more for my team if I just get huge. So all I need to do is just sit here and farm. Now, if I had an oppressive lane where I couldn't just sit here, I might take something different so I can go around the map and get kills instead to get money. But I don't need to, you know? It's kind of a trade-off, you know? You have to pick one or the other, basically. Are you going to gank or are you going to farm? And I'm quite a big fan of the free farm, because I find myself very good at it. I have no issue sitting in a lane and taking farm. I don't get pushed out of lane very often. I push other people out of lane usually. And I'm pretty efficient at it. Like, I've probably missed, like, 7 last hits overall. Yeah, that's a problem. If your team starts being super aggressive, you have to try your best to nicely tell them that you're not ready. The good thing about Spectre is that Spectre can be in the process of farming and still show up for the fight, which I love about Spectre. But if your team is trying to take fights that you're not ready for, you have to tell them, like, look, I'm not going to show up if you start a fight. I don't have anything. Like, right now, am I going to show up for a fight? No. What am I going to do? I could try. You know, I'll give an attempt, but it's not going to do much. Now, once I get my Radiance, then I'll be able to matter in a fight. Thus, I'll be more likely to rotate and you know, get into one. You have to find just that right balance. It is true. What MMR are you at, if you don't mind me asking? Because it definitely changes the ability to team play a lot, depending on your MMR. Right. I mean, you're just getting out of the bracket where people don't listen to anybody. If you can just raise yourself a little bit, then you'll be in a position where people do actually listen. Ah, that jerk. He has a Shadow Blade. Dang. Because they do start listening more once you pass 3K. You get a lot more people who are willing to actually say, like, oh, look, you know, I'll give you a Tango. I'll help you buy wards. You know, I'll ward your lane. Oh, you don't want to fight? That's okay. I'll back up. It's not perfect, but it gets better as you get higher. I hear it's worse as you get super high because, recalibrate. Nice. I recalibrated, I only got a couple hundred above where I was. I think 220. But it still counts. I mean, you know, that's a free MMR if you want to look at it that way. Usually comes once a year, so it's always nice to have the ability to, recalibrate in case you think you've gotten a lot better. I'm not going over there. It's not worth it. See, now they're pinging me, but I know I can't kill Shadow Fiend. He's too fast. Same thing with Templar. I can't kill her either. Yeah. That's what you get, though. I'm actually hitting her right now because I'm getting hit by creeps. She blinked, though. We're not going to get her. She's going to TP out. I'm going to send up Magic Community himself. I'm hoping to get him through the reflection damage. Oh, Shadow Fiends. I'm dead. I'm so dead. No. Ugh. Yeah, jungling is if you have a Vanguard and Dispersion, you can jungle all day. You'll never be low. If Death Prophet takes this tower, it'll be a little bit more worth it what happened, but still not great. Me dying is a big deal. I'm actually a little bit irritated because I only ended up having one person in my lane after the first, like, 2 minutes. And yet I feel like the enemy team has more money than they should. But what are you going to do? And he only has a Shadow Blade, but he is going for a Silver Edge to be a jerk. No, they don't. I don't have a Radiance yet. Now, granted, I can totally kill this Bristle if I can get close enough to him. Immune to physical. No reason I'm going to go after him now. And I'll just go back to farming. Don't have ult. Not going to catch him. Not that fast. Because of Bristleback, I might actually take movement speed this game. I'm thinking about it. Because their burst isn't as scary. I'll consider it. Both options would be fair. And remember, when you're farming a Spectre, jungle especially, the biggest creep is always last. So you can get that sweet, sweet Desolate on the lone creep. Always last, because now I'm doing an extra 65 pure damage because he's the only creep. Why waste it on a little creep? That would be pointless. You save yourself the most time doing it that way. He has a gem, so that's very aggressive, actually. I don't know why he has a gem this early. I'm going to take the Ancients, and then I should have enough for my Sacred Relic. There's a back wanded, that's very bad for us. We can still do it. Yes. That was huge. That was so big. And now, just like a good Spectre, go buy my Sacred Relic immediately so I do not lose the money. I'm a little bit slow on my farm now thanks to the death. But I'm getting there. Awesome. Well played, Abaddon. We're deciding to actually get an item that we will all benefit from. I get over here fast so it stops pushing. Whew. My ult's still on cooldown, so I can't really do much in that regard. Ooh, money. Nice. We got a tower. That's a big deal. Yes, that's true. The thing is, and I've had this discussion a couple times with different people, in general, on most heroes, phase boots are better early game. They end up giving you more damage potential in the early game, and more killability in the early game, but they really make you suffer in the late game. Power treads are way stronger late game, for damage potential and all that. So I always like to build for the late game, so I almost always build power treads on carries. Now, sometimes there's exceptions, because some heroes really struggle with kiting, so they kind of have to have phase boots no matter what. But it's something you have to do on an at, you know, decide at on the moment of when you're buying them. This particular game, I'm worried about facing, you know, Juggernaut late game. I need more damage and more attack speed. Especially TA, because I have to break her dispersion. And as much as Radiant does a good job of doing that, Radiance, it also helps to attack faster. Because then those hits are out of the way quicker. So, in my opinion, I'm going to go for the treads for that late game potential, and then I'll probably get the move speed to, you know, assist me in catching up with them. I don't think the stats are necessary here. So, Diffusal Blade, here I come. Actually, yeah, never mind. I don't even need to take the move speed. I'm going to have a Diffusal Blade. I'm going to purge them. I'm not jumping in now. That's ridiculous. Why say something? Nobody said they're roaching. I didn't know why he was picking me. I used ult just because I wanted to mark where they were on the map to give my team an ability to react. Yeah, I mean, just speak. Just say something. It's very helpful. That's all it takes. It's actually that easy. Look at how far fed she is. She has a Deso, an Orchid, and a Blink Dagger. My Radiance is very expensive, but then I have a Vanguard. That's my only other item. Like, you know, what allowed her to get this farmed early? She's level 18. Jesus. Nice. Radiance burn. And now I gotta go stop this nonsense. He already ulted, but I know he has a Silver Edge, so I'm really just chasing him away at this point. You know, get off my lawn, that kind of thing. I can't do anything else about him. He TP'd out, so I'm safe now. These guys are killing me right now. We're doing well overall, but TA is much stronger than I would hope. Fortunately, she lost Aegis and died, so I'm happy about that. Zero, one, and one. I don't know how. She has so much money, you'd think she'd have better score, but apparently not. Alright, let these respawn real quick. Back again. That would actually help, you're right. I mean, creeps are worth a little bit less, like the tiniest bit, but yeah, that would definitely probably help. Our mid was, who, Death Prophet? Goodbye. I don't think it's worth really pursuing this. Nope. And she can't go anywhere because Radiance. Now she can. Yep, there she goes. Unfortunate. What are you gonna do, right? We still got the Omni and the Bristle. Yeah, she's doing okay. She's got stuff going on. I like her pickup too. I love the Rod of Atos. No thanks. This will mark her. Now we can see where she goes. Shadow Fiend's coming, so I gotta back. Tread switch.
No, 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 wait here, wait here, wait here. This is a trap for them.
That worked really well, actually. Good trap.
We forced the ult.
Tread switch. I'm still alive. Barely. I unfortunately have to get out. I can't really risk this anymore. I'll throw a dagger at Jug if he shows again.
Awesome.
Just to help Abaddon. Jug has entered the game. Yeah, that's about right.
As long as Speck gets up, it's okay.
The Shakiro has been on point. This Shakiro has been going crazy. I'm very surprised.
Too many armor. Once DP gets Shivas.
Shivas would be cool. I would really appreciate it if you got Shivas. Alright, mark Shadow Fiends. He'll be afraid because he does not want people to know where he is. I can't really go any farther than that. Not alone. I'm gonna say I actually need to get my Manta so I'm not silenced anymore. Because TA is gonna try to silence me. So that I can't ult, so I can't throw dagger, that kind of stuff. So I gotta get Manta, and then I think Scotty, because it's gonna also help my move speed. The fact that I didn't take it.
I actually think we're okay. Like, their team fight is, like, so-so. Our team fight's, like, really good.
I'm definitely thinking Scotty. Heart is good, though. It's better on Spectre than ever, since it took away some strength and added more health. And it's cheaper. So, I'm not sure. I'm a little bit conflicted.
Gotta be careful when we use our ult.
Ah, Diffusal. Look at that damage.
Careful. They may have vision here. I mean, somebody has a gem.
Yeah, I think I definitely need the Manta, though, to throw off silence, and it also spreads amongst the Jug Omni Slash, so that helps, too. Yeah, I mean, Scotty gives you, I want to say, let me remember correctly, 500 health. Heart gives you 500 health, plus another 800 health. Yeah. So it gives you 800 health more and better popping in and out of team fights because of the passive regen. But Scotty gives you, it gives you half as much, but then it also gives you armor, damage, spell amp, that kind of stuff. So, you know, it's really hard to say. I want to use damage to Spectre, so I'm a little bit, I don't love buying heart, but it's not bad. It's still a really good item because that massive just HP pool means dispersion is that much better. So it really depends on the particular matchup.
Yeah, then give it to me.
I should actually probably hold the gem, but I don't mind. Nice. Whew. Can't move. I wish that he had detection. To be honest. He's dead. Nice. Oh my god, that was huge.
Why
do.
Why didn't you just hit the F? Oh well.
I think The only problem is we don't have a lot of damage late game. Death Prophet will do a lot of damage late game, but Abaddon will be kind of meh, like so-so. And Jakiro and Treant will, you know, fall off. So I'm a little worried that I won't have the late game that I'm hoping for, but I'll decide after I got my manta. I'll see how I'm doing in team fights after my manta, and then I'll decide whether or not I need the extra HP or the, you know, survivability.
Yeah, we're gonna watch out.
I end up fighting ability. Fortunately, manta gives me some health. Throwing dagger to help push that wave. That's true, it should help. I'm a little worried there's so many of them over there, we're gonna have a problem.
This is fucking amazing.
Okay. He's gonna die anyway. I guess not. He wasted ults. Oh crap, that's huge.
That wasn't even worth it for them.
Yeah, right. Please. Please.
LOL.
There it is.
There we go. I'll get it when I come back. Can I give you the wards?
Oh man, that was gorgeous. The reason I quick switched it with my ult is I figured the Jug might get confused. It cancels his auto attack when you switch, if I remember correctly. So it like gives him that moment of pause, which gives me just enough extra time to attack him where he's not attacking me.
We got both the gems. We got our other ones back. See, look, I'm gonna deward all these little traps. He had traps on our ancient.
There's Jug. I can't take him yet. Because he has ult, and I don't have my manta to throw off the illusions. Look at this tree set, by the way. It's nice.
Yeah, but he's so squishy.
Excuse me, I'm sorry. Alright, so I don't think I need the survivability, because even when I was just doing it...
Abaddon almost has Silver Edge, which is nice.
It's the light head of the Aegis... It's the Aegisless Winter so set, that's what it is. Purple. I'm not familiar with it myself.
Oh, shit.
I'm thinking the Scotty will be okay. I'm skeptical to say so, but it doesn't seem like they do that much damage to me. You know what I mean? They can't. They just run, so I need to slow them so I can actually catch up with them. Oh, bye, Shadow Fiends. Yeah. This is worth it. How'd you guys like that sudden ult into killing TA? I was trying to get out, but I saw that one hero was there. I knew it wasn't Shadow Fiend, Bristleback, or Omni. So I was like, there's no negative, you know what I mean? Like, I'll be fine. No matter who it is, because I know right now TA close range has no ability to kill me. And I was right. She literally didn't touch me. She turned around, basically screamed, and died. Yeah. So, you know, it was both, obviously. It was a reaction to the situation to get out, but I figured the chances were I'd either chase them away or kill them. Another reason why not to bother with the heart is because I got the 400 health anyway at level 25. So, you know. Doesn't mean it's not. I could have all of it, of course. I could have a heart and all the rest, but, you know. I think I'll get a Scotty, and then I'll probably buy a Abyssal Blade, which will also boost my health anyway. I'll have a lot of health items in the end. That's the wonderful thing about Spectre. You can just get health from so many different places. Can't be there, unfortunately. I would love to be. Especially since Bristol's low. But if the fight goes kind of well, then I can just take this top tower. Not sure how they're doing, how the enemy health is. Not really willing to ult to find out, though.
I tried. I thought I could sneak a...
That's what we have Abaddon with one.
Overgrowth there for you to get out, but...
It's just kind of a waste on Spectre because it doesn't give, like, a lot of great stats versus other carry-ish items. It would be good otherwise. If there was nobody else to carry it, yeah, I'd have to get one. I'm getting so rich and I love it. This is how you farm a Spectre. 40 minutes in, I get three. Oh, dang. I should have seen that coming. I'll be ready for the fight, but I gotta push this out. Did you just go invis? What the heck was that? Oh crap. That was really bad. Oh, he blinked, okay. A little bit short. It looks like I may have distracted him long enough for our team to get something going. It looks like Jug's about to die. Oh, maybe not, though. That's sad. Just, they have to play it safe until I come back, basically. Yeah, I don't know. I thought that they wouldn't all come so fast, so I'd be able to do something when I jumped in the Omni Knight, but that's not what happened. It's Omni Knight. No, he doesn't have a blank. Oh, it was Glimmer Cape. Glimmer Cape. Fortunately, it seems like they're going to rebuff them long enough.
Really, really good defense. There's no need to like jump in and try to chase them or anything. They have to fight into us. I mean,
fact, that's exactly what happened. I just got greedy. I wanted him so bad.
Yeah, because the issue is you can't actually kill him solo. I mean, you can't, but you can't defusal his shit off, so. Sucks we didn't get this, but she still has cheese. Thought I popped that.
She still has Aegis. Oh, jeez. That's not good. Alright, well, I'm gonna be there, I guess.
I want them to, like, jump into us.
I'm trying to think about how best we can really have a fight. I'm trying to save the hero here.
Easy Silver Edge. It's so good against Whistle.
I'm wondering what I should do here. I have friends. Yes, for friends. Welcome back to the fight, TA. She did not know we were coming back so fast. That is probably GG. Because we're just going to take the racks and probably just go for, probably going to go for the throne, the ancients. off the aggro from the tower because I don't want to unnecessarily be low. Alright, we've broken high ground. That's always big. Shadow Fiend's going to try to get inside of us here, but I think Treant still... Yeah, he still has gem, so that's not going to work. I'll save for buyback just to be safe.
Yeah, kill their shrines. I'm just gonna run around their fours putting down stuff.
They're mostly up and in their base they have a lot more power. It's like Treant can't go in and ult because there's no trees. So that's one of our concerns. Also, I'm hoping they get angry enough that they chase and then they're dead. Yeah, we probably could have, but I think a lot of our stuff was down. Like, at the time, Treant ult was still down, I believe. Oh, maybe not. He has really low cooldown. My ult was down. I guess Exorcism is still down. So it would have been a little bit of a worse fight. We don't want to take any unnecessary fights. I mean, we got a shrine. We got the whole Rax. We're going to get the other shrine at some point. We're going for it next. I don't think we want to risk anything. I have ult, but it's Jug and TA, so that doesn't sound good to me. Does not sound like a good deal, you know? I'll head my way over to Death Prophet to help her, but first...
I'm just stacking up these things. We have these, like, all over the place.
I want to try to do my best to get my Scotty. Still need 200 more gold. That's unfortunate. Hopefully we can take this bottom tower now that we have both shrines. We just increased our net worth significantly. I guess somebody is being very loud in the background, and I don't know why.
Oh, I think he popped it too early. Dang. Well, I think we could just take a fight. Just take a fight, then.
And Scotty. I could go, but it seems like the bad idea, you know what I mean? We never have any detection. Oh, he went back significantly lower health. Something positive to that anyway. I really wish that Abaddon had, you know, detection at all, so we could have hit him earlier, but it is what it is. My team stayed in too long, unfortunately. Oh, first hit bashed by the Jug, that's painful.
Yeah, we can't actually do that. We have to 5-man. We can't go 3v5. We'll lose the fight.
Yeah, they stayed even though they knew I was gone. Semi illusions to go hit tower. They don't last very long, but
use it?
I mean, I don't know if that was right.
I just killed their creep waves, so they can't do anything else.
That's helpful, I guess. Low cooldown ability, right? And get again on marking him. I want to go in, but it's I'm not set up here for success.
Oh,
Come on. I got him first. It was worth it. All worth. We just got a buyback from Shadow Fiend, and I don't need to buy back.
Oh, we got a tier 2 up top.
Oh, we did. Oh, look at that.
I actually have enough for Octarine.
That was great.
I'm happy.
Oof.
You guys about to witness just the absolute horror of a tree that has farm.
Shadow Fiend's trying to split push still. His butterfly is killing me, actually.
I'm trying to get up trees everywhere so we have vision.
Alright, looks like we might take bottom racks. Maybe. They're buying back, though.
That's good, that's good. We're forced to buy back. Okay. Excellent.
She stopped the push, so that's good. We got another buyback out of it. That's good. Absolutely. Every time. If you die, probably. If you die before
I'm gonna put shit all over
them,
the roof pit so we can just
you get zero experience. You cannot get experience while you're dead. The only exception to that, I think, is Moonshard did that for a while. I don't know if it still does. So always, 100% of the time, you want to make sure that you're alive when they die. You know what I mean? It makes a big difference. Because now, because of it, I mean, I'm level 25, but I get more gold. Shadow Fiend gets less because Shadow Fiend experiences a gold loss for the unreliable first. Kills give you reliable. It's weird. And if there was experience to gain, he gets none. I mean, I think he's level 25 too. He's been 25, but in general, it's just a better idea.
I mean, we have full coverage of the pit, though, with overgrowth. I mean, we could just force Roche. We have all of our ults, right? Yep.
True. He's right.
They really can't contest. If they do that, they just lose the game. Over. Oh, no, you destroyed my trees! What? What are you doing? Dude, you destroyed all the trees!
It looks like this fight's going kind of meh. But it's still happening, I mean. Gotta be here. And the slow... Oh, Tick, she's dead. That's GG. They can't possibly stop us now. Omni-Knight does nothing to stop us, basically.
Just go in. They can't actually fight us, I don't think.
That is... Yeah, I don't care. Look at all the items I have just sitting around. The Sega completion looks better. GG, well played. And this was the game with 1,000 tokens on it, wasn't it? Oh, yes. And you know who's getting a tip? My good friend. Mr. Tree. Oh, yes. What do I get for my reward, friends? A blink effect. I'm not going to pretend I'm overly excited about it, but, you know. And he tipped me back. Good guy. That's how you know. I'll play another one, even though it's almost time where I would stop. I think I got time for another one. So, I gained 23 MMR, so that's nice. We're up to 3,339. This one didn't... Which one was it? This one didn't really count because it wasn't international ranked, which is sad, but that's okay. So far, I still have a 2 net gain, so that's nice. Let's look at this match as soon as I can get to this match. So the reason I'm one, before I even look, I already know my net worth was ridiculous. 28,000. The only person even close to me in the game was Juggernaut, and he was still 2,000 below me in net worth. Largely because of the buybacks, though, I'll be honest. I know that. So, like, I would have been right behind Jug if it weren't for the buybacks, but that's what it is. So, pretty much all of the game, I was pretty far up there. The only problem I was experiencing is that TA and Shadowfiend were also farming incredibly well. So even if, as I started to like get a lot of farm, then Jug jumped in there too. They were all farming off my team, and they had good lanes as well. That was one of our early game problems, is that they were allowed to get farm. The good thing, however, is that as a whole, our team... Actually, yeah, no, we were so far behind. I didn't even realize how far behind we were. It didn't seem like it. They had a huge advantage for such a long time, but they just don't have team fight. Bristleback is team fight, and Omnite's kind of team fight. Shadowfiend kind of sucks at team fight. Templar sucks at team fight, and Jug kind of sucks because while he's ulting, he can't control what he's doing. So there's just, if one target just takes it and can like survive it, he's just kind of useless. He's way better at solo killing. I'm really good at team fight because I survive. I deal damage out to everybody who's near me. Jakiro locks them down, does a ton of damage. Treant has one of the best ults for team fights in the game. Death Prophet has exorcism and silence, an AoE silence, and Abaddon can run in there and slow people down, and they can't stop him because of his ult. Basically, the reason we won was mostly because we forced our advantage. We forced team fights. We said, if you want our towers, we're going to fight you for it, and they'll lose. And so they did, and they would lose. They may have farmed a lot better than us, but it doesn't matter. It doesn't balance out. We ended up getting a lot of our net worth back that we were losing. During this time here, we started getting a lot of our net worth back as we got good team fights, and we started getting big items. So like near the end, you know, I got my Scotty. We had an Ags on Jakiro, Ags on Tree, a Shiva's into an Octarine Core on our Death Prophet. After the Silver Edge on Abaddon, we got a Heaven's Halberd. I didn't notice that, but that's great. And even got a Manta Style to throw off the Silence. So basically, they did fine early game. We had a problem with our farm, but we just forced the advantage. We forced team fights. We basically did the 5-man Dota. They should have split pushed, but Shadowfiend wasn't strong enough to split push solo without the risk of dying, so he really, because Spectre counters split pushers. So I held him back even without doing anything. Just by existing, I held him back. So Invoker disarms people. I'll need to build a BKB carrier. Or Slark, who throws off all the magic he does anyway. I can play a Slark game. It's been a while. I ban NP every single game because at level 25, he's the best split pusher in the game because he can remove his TP cooldown as a talent. They just changed that in the 7.06 update. Slark's really good against Jug, by the way, so I'm definitely feeling this. I'm good against Jug. I can throw off Invoker stuff, and I can out-carry Gyrocopter in theory. And Dragonite just isn't that good of a hero, so I'm not worried about it. I'm actually going to get the poor man's shield for safety. But the reason I ban him isn't... it can be, but I'm not worried about it, because if he's trying to cast only on me, because I'm not going to be next to my team, then whoever picks mid will just be killing him. Jakiro's going to lock him down anyway, so is Centaur, and so is Leshrac. We have a ton of stuns. So I don't worry about... Sunstrike could hurt me in theory, because Sunstrike, if it hits me during ult, it's probably going to kill me. But... I mean, Chaos Meteor does damage over time, and Slark can just purge that anyway. You just walk out of it in Dark Pact. I can get rid of his disarm. You know, I'm not too worried about it. I mean, I could get hurt, but I don't think so. It is a risk, though. But the NP has no TP no cooldown on his teleportation. If he gets an Octarine Core, he can literally sprout you forever. Pretty much, he can sprout you forever. His Treants get super strong late game, so his push is ridiculous, especially with the consistent buffs to split push and nerfs to 5-manning. His base damage has been increasing, so he's actually able to gank early, like level 2. He can actually do enough damage to kill people. He's just so strong right now. And at my MMR, I see it more often, like when I'm playing non-ranked games too. I see it more often that it's just obnoxious. I don't want to see it. I don't want to play against it. I don't want to deal with it. It's just annoying. And yes, Disco Horse, my teammates. I'll predict because I believe in us. Good luck, have fun, friends. I'll queue up for a... You can't buy Orvenom out of Side Shop anymore, can you? I don't think so. I do kind of want one. We'll see. I'll either get Orvenom if the lane's going well, or my boots if it's going poorly. Always have to build based on how the lane's going. Apparently he does not speak English. What are you going to do? I'm 1 point of agility away from having 3 armor. Makes me a little bit sad. Fortunately, when I level up, I will have 1 more point of agility. Is that what he said? I didn't know you spoke different languages. I'll remember that. I'll have you translate from now on. You'll be my official translator. Let's get bot tower. Yeah, I mean, they could probably push pretty easily. I kind of expected Shakira would be with me, though. I mean, Leshrac's fine, but... Ricky's here, so I'll ping that real quick. Ricky hitting me. He tried. I'm alone, so I wasn't going to be able to do anything about him. We gonna slay. What's up with this guy's lingo? What a strange dude. And a poor man's shield on Centaur seems strange, too. It's not necessarily bad strange, but I don't think I've ever seen it before. Because he's not an agility hero. I guess he still gets, you know, the armor, basically, for it. And the extra damage block, but... It just seems weird. Oh, Dragonite? Essence shift all day. He's out of lane. Doesn't even matter, you know? This Ricky's gonna annoy me this whole game. Probably realize it's like I don't have... Oops, I blocked him. I'll buy boots first, then I'll get the Orb of Venom. So I can't have, This way I can actually stand and fight this guy. Dead. A good game call already. These guys are fun. A lot of people don't remember that Slark has an amazing capability to kill people early. I mean, if you're Slark and you know you get Essence Shift early, heroes who can't stun you, which Dragonite can, but he really can't. He's very bad at it. They suffer. Like, what does Dragonite do about me right now? He just takes it. I don't know why, Thank you. Oh my god, this is the best support ever. Do you guys see that? He's gonna buy me a healing salve. Who does that? I could barely get my friends to do that. He sent me, of course. Ricky's revealed, I don't know if he realizes that. No! Ah. Creep vision. No, I'm not gonna allow him to blame himself. It's fine. It just stinks, you know? I'm not really strong enough right now to fight them both. Ricky's not supposed to be good in lane, but I guess he's just, like, manning up. Leshrac, realistically, should have been back a lot faster. He's got, like, no experience, so Leshrac doesn't have lightning, doesn't have lightning storm, which is really good for chasing. And one of the reasons we're suffering now is because he just doesn't have, you know, enough damage to really make it happen. I would get... I guess I'll get a Dark Pact. I'm not going to use it, but just in case I see, like, a... I can't even imagine who. I guess Gyro coming with Missile or something. It could help me there. But other than that, there's not a lot to purge early on. I just need level, there we go. I need level 6 really bad. Okie dokie. Now I'm relatively strong. I want Shadowblade first. I don't want to deal with all this other nonsense. There's Gyro. This is why I did it. Yep. He's going to hit me with it too. I went closer so that it did less damage. Because the stun doesn't matter. Can't believe there's three top now. Like, what are they doing? As always, I'm going solo in the safe lane. After like 2.5 minutes, 3 minutes, just me. Despite how bad that is. Unfortunately, yet again, I just have to suck it up. I'm so close to my ult, too. It makes me so upset. I don't know why he's random. Alright, I need it, so. That's just what it is. I don't feel bad. Oh man, I need my level. I need 6. When I get 6, I'll be much more dangerous. There's my ult healing me up. Oh, finally. I know Ricky can't see me because my ult's on. It just stinks because Ricky's actually acting like a support and staying with Dragonite, and I get crap. Nice try. dead. That's so unfortunate. I feel like I didn't deserve to die there. Jakiro messed up his ice bath, which wasn't cool. And we're just dying on a lot, actually. I'm surprised. How did he die? Juggernaut? Oh, it's Juggernaut ult. That would make sense. That should be a dead Ricky. Can't get him. He's just too tanky. There's Jakiro screwing up a last hit I could have gotten too. I'm getting frustrated now with my supports. I hoped. Yeah, the problem is Leap's range is deceptive. So, like, it's hard to actually get people sometimes. I need to level up my Essence Shift next, actually. Because I need to get this stuff to last. Otherwise, I can never kill Dragonite, because I need to actually keep it. Oh, that might have worked. Leap doesn't disjoint, though. It used to. It doesn't anymore, I don't think. Lightning Strike is a good ability, Lestrak, you know that? If we take this tower, then I get my level 1 challenge. Nice. Broke some trees. Nice. Oh no, they got a tower. There goes my challenge. Only level 1, I guess. That's okay. It's better than not getting it at all, right? So at this point in Slark, I'm just really weak. I don't have enough levels. I don't have enough money. So I just need to farm. Slushark refused to take Lightning Strike. Why? Why wouldn't he think I was going to the shrine? Of all places. Oh my god, that guy had me. I had ult on too, so he did not see me. That's so frustrating. This is all because I got no money in lane because I didn't have a support. Like, Lestrak refuses to take lightning. I spelled Lestrak like an idiot, but I'm just gonna accept it for what it is. That should be a dead jug. Not so cool that Shadow Fiend died though. Like, what's happening in this game? I just need to get a lot of farm right now. I need a Shadow Blade really bad, and it's very hard to do that when everywhere seems to be, you know, going poorly, basically. What about 7.0, I wonder? Oh, yeah. Supposed to. I set up Centaur. Can't get him drugs over there. Doesn't matter. At least I came to Jakira's rescue, right? Jakira didn't die. Ah, it was worth it. What do I get? Level 10. Lifesteal. That's what I'll be taking. Well, I don't know if that's true. Yeah, lifesteal. Damage isn't really that important. 15 damage is kind of lackluster. I think the lifesteal is the better bet, even though I don't really need it, because I have my ult and invis and stuff. It's just nice to have. That rune's gone. That makes me very sad. It also makes me worried, but I don't see anybody breaking my ult, so. I'll eventually get this. Not gonna bother using this because it's magic damage and these things are magic resistance anyway. I'm not gonna damage myself for it. Oh, I'm getting close. I almost had my Shadow Blade, friends. I had about 18 minutes. They take damage, but it's reduced. They're magic resistance. I think they have, like, so these things have their own aura, obviously. So these ones are magic resistant, too. But there's a base magic resistance increase in the golems. I think it's 50%. I could be wrong. So it would be inefficient. I'm just going to sit here because there's no reason to go back to base. It's a waste. But this is a safe way to regen. Just in case they walk by, they won't see me. No, you cannot. I think I might say that. You can't kill yourself with this skill. Unfortunate, but it is what it is. I do more damage now thanks to the passive of the Shadow Blade, some damage, some attack speed. I guess the Invoker just wants to hurt me. Yeah, you can go to one. which is very risky. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and get Essence Shift up. Just so I can get those cool, he has an armlet, I'm not messing with that. No thanks. With Shadow Fiend, though, more reasonable. There's nothing gonna happen there that's good. So, never mind. Yeah, oh yeah, I gotta deny them, you're right. I don't know why it's so negative. Everybody's so negative. I'm just actually gonna mute him. Yeah, exactly. It's just the negativity of Dota. Best advice, mute it, ignore. It's not worth getting into. It's not gonna make you feel better. It's just gonna make everybody angrier. I'm trying to have fun, learn some things, teach some things. I don't need this crap. Basically. PMA. Define your acronym, because I'm not familiar with it. Oh, absolutely. You have to not get frustrated when you play Dota, or you will not play Dota for long. This fight is going, like, literally the worst. I don't know what the plan was there, but it wasn't good. I don't know why we're moving on them. Right, it's fine to lose. It's fine to lose as long as the game was fun and you learned something from it. You know what I mean? So, like, we could still have a good time and lose. Yes. I'm a little bit more vocal when I'm not on stream because, like, I actually have conversations with people. But obviously I don't, you know, focusing on you guys, not them. It's very important to, like, bring that positive mental attitude to other people and spread it. As far as I'm concerned, anybody who's a jerk can just stop playing Dota. I don't want to play with you, you know? Okay. He has a defusal? I didn't know he had a defusal. I couldn't ult. Oh, crap. I should have checked. It's my own fault. I should have checked. I'm pretty sure the centaur was in range to cast double edge. Maybe not. It's pretty small range. That defusal really screwed me. I had ult ready, all that stuff. I didn't know. That's gonna make Ricky incredibly hard for me to kill. It's because he got farm. Because he was allowed to get farm, you know? If we had had more help top, he wouldn't have farm. Like, I'm broke. I have nothing right now. But we still have a chance. We just have to play around that. That's how Dota works. Just to get my Echo Saber so I can actually kind of fight people. I don't know if I can take these. I can. Look at that. That was cool. Set me up for success there, so I appreciate that. What's next? At this point in the game, I might need to do BKB Slark. Maybe a Basher. Maybe a quick Basher just to help the... No, you know what I need? I lied. You think of BKB? Yeah, I will. I don't want to because it's going to kill my ability to do any damage, but it stops a lot. Can't fight Gyro with his ult. His axe, I mean. That was huge. That was so big. And I got this, because obviously we need to take it. And prevent it from being taken. I don't want to take my own tower. Yeah, exactly. You're right. I need more agility since I'll have BKB to survive their burst anyway. Build into it, you know what I mean? If I'm gonna have survivability, I don't need to build more survivability. That seems kind of pointless. Dead. That's so oh, Guardian Greaves. Can't help him. Bought out, so there was a positive there. You think so? I don't know. It gets me farm really fast, which is oh, kill him. Yes. I definitely picked up, by the way. I'm much more, you know, relevant now. Healing ward, that's money. It's like 100. Oh, the slow is destroying him there. He wants to cast, but his far one isn't ready. That's so unfortunate. I'll show up in case Shadow Fiend needs me. I'm just afraid to do it near their side of the map because it'll lower me down. I don't want to be low in case they're going to jump on me like jerks. This just purged me. Oh no, it didn't. Still dead. I should have dark backed it because it purges immediately and then it would have brought me to one. Not gonna work out in our favor, unfortunately. That's true. He's got a good point. Why bother going in after I die? Just let me die, you know? Invoker has a Gem of True Sight. Oh, that explains a lot. Can't do much about him, he has a gem. Wait for Shadow Fiend, see what we can do. I distracted them. Job well done. I want to take this haste. Yeah, it ruins me, it ruins Jakiro, it ruins Shadow Fiend. Centaur. It doesn't hurt Lestrak too much because he's going to have mana regen, but he's the only one. And he's out. No thanks. Inside that nonsense. I don't know which way he's going, but I'm gonna try to get him. Got him. Yes! Suffer, Ricky! Yeah, the DK is pretty bad. He just thinks he's immortal and he's not. That explosion. Oh my god, did you see that? Invoker's going to throw a tornado or EMP, so I got to be a little bit careful here. I'm not trying to, have that happen. I got nothing. Bristle did. I guess they're just not taking the hint and they're gonna die for it. These extra stacks are helping me take this super fast. I had to save for buyback, but... trying to get my BKB super fast. Okay. Back to base to mana. It's ridiculous, you know what I mean? Like, they just don't listen. Couldn't even ult in time. That was bad. I'll have to buy back. Good thing I didn't waste my ult, I guess. I mean, I would have liked to live, but they just knew I was there. They must have had a ward on my TP, my TPN. Really bad. I'm dead. We just don't have enough going on. That's okay though. We'll end up basically breaking even for the day, so. Or am I wrong? That's not true. We'll end up one down. Whatever. Unless they just don't push for some strange reason. Ugh. Is a gem again. If Sekiro needs to try to ice path before ult. If you ult first, they have a chance to react to it and move out of the way, and then they're not going to be inside that ice path, you know? Where's Lushrak going? Oh, I see. He thinks he can get him. I feel tempted to disagree, but they did get Dragonite. I mean, this is actually a great comeback for the base defense, I mean, not a comeback for the game. It does give us a chance to do something. Alrighty, well, I'm gonna sell this, get this, buy that. And I'll join this little fight. Ugh. Okay, well, Jahiro just recalled my BKB for some reason. Game's not over, man. Not yet. Alright, I need a Scotty. Need survivability. Need to be able to, you know, take down someone better. Gonna be a while, but I gotta do it. Levels so I can get my actually wondering what's better. I don't think Pounce Leash matters as much because they can usually get out of it anyway. I'm thinking that the stats will be better just so I can survive. Wow. What was that? That was ridiculous. Yeah, that's fine. I can go over there. Jar was just there. Gotta get ready to BKB, I guess. My lifesteal's kicking in. Oh my god, that was ridiculous. Highlight reel. That was scary, dude. I'm lucky I didn't miss that last hit. I should have. Here come the buybacks. Get him. Okie dokie. So, we just got racks, which is ridiculous to consider because we were not in a place to get them. But I'm pleased. That's huge. That is so big. I need that so bad. I can buy at least one of these now. Ooh, that looks like a lot of money. Arcane bot, I'll take that. If nobody else is gonna take it. Ricky is my target. He doesn't have anything extra to stop me now. I ulted for safety. It's also on a low cooldown. It has no vision, so I've set my team up for success here. It's worth, you know what I mean? I'm regenerating the whole time I'm throwing in the air anyway. He can ghost walk on me, except that I am Slark with Gem. I can't see him. He's far. He's fast. He's gone. Unfortunate, but that's reality. Waste of a BKB charge, unfortunately. Hopefully I'll get my level 25 real soon, because that'll give me a lot more power to fight, because I'll have a lot more health and other such things. There it is. I definitely support the 12 stats, because they just break it all the time anyway. I'd actually like to have a silver edge at some time. Oh, we did. That's true. I'm coming, but it's taking time. He's TPing out. He's gone. Oh, Roche. Sure. Sorry, I meant to ping that. I'll come and hit it a little bit, and then we'll... Ult. Oh, yes. Oh, my God. That was huge again. I don't care about buyback. I need this. Money time. There's our net worth fixing. Oh, that's huge. All right, I'll cut the wave, I guess. Oh, I can't. It's too far away. When I eventually get the chance, I'll upgrade to a Silver's Edge just so I can use it more often. A little more damage when I initiate. That kind of stuff. It's taking forever to actually get my buyback. There we go. I've heard the percentage of Slark games that are won once Slark has a Scotty are like astronomical. Like he always wins if he gets a Scotty, I guess is the rule. Still got two heroes dead, so I'm looking to find a you know, catch somebody while they're out. That's my goal here. I'm also hoping to go to the secret shop and maybe find the courier. That would be even better. No thanks. We should not be fighting. I don't have anything. We gotta just get out, get out. Not worth it. Gotta sacrifice my team if that's what it's gotta be. Shadow Fiend is pushing during this entire thing, so as long as some of us survive, it'll be fine. Alright, they've all surrounded him. Which means he's probably gonna die. Yep. But it's after 40 minutes, so we get both runes. So I'm gonna haste invis and kill somebody. I don't know who yet. Jug is supposed to be a good target, but he's preventing it. That looks fake. No, he just phased. What was that? Yeah, I guess. Alright, there's multiple. No thanks. There's like four. We don't want to get into this fight without Shadow Fiend. Fortunately, Shadow Fiend's coming now, but. Nice. Alts. This is how Slark is supposed to be played. Oh, man. Regen rune I don't need. I'm loving that stuff, man. It's huge right now. I do not have BKB up, and that's a huge problem. But that's okay. He already uses Tornado, so I'll just take the creep wave. Bye. Wasn't ideal, but it'll do. That's okay. I lived. He did not. No thanks. Oh no, that was bad. I'm gonna freaking live. I'm going to freaking live. Oh my god, that's so good. And that's Silver's Edge. After that, I mean, I don't know. I guess an Abyssal Blade would be nice. Eventually, one day. I still have buyback. I lived. Oh my god, this is great. Who's down there? I'm not afraid of either of them, so if Ricky's not there, then I'm set. And I'll know if Ricky's there because I have gem, so. Oh my god, these stats. I'm so happy this game turned around in my favor. Even if I lose, I'm at least happy I was able to go crazy. I have more stacks than he does Necromastery. And that's 126 agility, by the way. It's not 42, it's 42 stacks of 3. That's how that whole jazz works. All right, we got to kind of back, though, unfortunately. Get back. Back with the team. Well, I can't give anything up right now anyway, though. It's like to make room. Thank you. No reason to pop it. Fine. Good. Come on, guys. Make sure it happens. My team is not as helpful as I would hope. They did take the tower, though, which is nice. Shakira was bottom for some strange reason. I guess he's taking the tower, but it wasn't worth it. Dang. I keep sneezing. I'm dead for a while. Not as dead as long as Shakira, but I'm dead for a while. I don't know if they'll be able to push fast enough. The main problem is I can't take them all at once. There's just too much lockdown, even for my my Dark Pact. I also don't have a gem anymore, which changes things. Shakira's buyback. Shadafiend's still on cooldown, right? Yep. They're pushing mid for some strange reason. They're not gonna... Okay, they're rotating. Oh, crud. I just tornadoed all the time. I'm dead. I'm actually dead. I gotta stop chasing Evoker and actually focus on, you know, any hero. It's so sad to lose this way. This will be an interesting game to analyze. It's also the last game, so everybody knows. So this will be relatively quick. I'll try to wrap it up so you guys don't have to listen to me drone on too much. So today, this doesn't count, like I said, because it was the wrong MMR. I lost 46, gained 23, so I lost 23. Not too bad. So that game. Shadowfiend had as much money as I did. In fact, Centaur had as much money as I did. But in the end, they were not nearly as effectual. We wouldn't expect Centaur to be, but Shadowfiend really wasn't holding his own anymore. Probably because of his itemization. He got an Axe, which did not end up, you know, helping too much. I'm also curious what he did for his talents. So he didn't do anything that gave him powers towards his ult, but still bought an Axe, I guess, for the extra right click. I don't agree with that. It would have been better if he had a butterfly or something. Personal opinion. That's okay, though. I'm not going to pretend he's the only issue. I farmed very poorly early, and we're about to see that. They had an advantage most of the game, to be honest. My net worth was crap early, but I caught up around 40 minutes, and then I got a respectable amount for myself. Shadowfiend was ahead, and I'm shocked, because I never saw that. And I guess Centaur was ahead, which is good, too. The problem is that for most of the game, it was, you know... The start, we had an advantage, but then most of the game, it was... Actually, I guess it was pretty mixed. It was pretty mixed, but they just... Invoker had too much money. Ricky was too strong because we didn't have a good counter to him. I mean, we had gems all over the place, but it just didn't matter. I mean, this Midas was not good. It would have been great if he was stronger earlier, so he would have had more presence around the map. This is a problem. He built fine. That's fine. My items were really slow. Huge downtime here because I was getting crapped on. Takiro, that's fine. He should have bought mobility, because a 4-staff would have been great to push people out of Ricky smoke. That never happened to me. I never once had someone help me get out of smoke, but whatever. It would have actually been nice if we had a Crimson Guard, but I guess I didn't expect it. BKB, that's fine. Did he buy BKB? The Shadow Fiend? Because he probably should have. Yeah, he didn't, and he needed one too. You know, because that's how you counter Invoker. You buy BKB and you ignore him. But what are you going to do, I guess? Realistically, they just had more money than us most of the game. They farmed better, and my lane went crappy because it was already a hard lane as it was, and my support didn't stay at all. I had to solo lane for a long time, and it made it so I got no last hits early. I did end up kind of catching up, but the problem was my team didn't stay strong. They have a Jug, a Dragonite, a Ricky, an Invoker, and a Gyro. They're all carries. We should have won this game early, but they outlaned us somehow. I really don't know how. And we paid for it in the late game because we just could not keep up anymore. So I was useless early game. Centaur was useless early game because of a Midas buy. And the other three couldn't keep the game going, I guess, because it wasn't good lane rotations. And that was basically why we lost. But, you know, stuff happens. Only lost 23. That's better than a lot of the other days. And considering how much we won last time, 76, that's okay. So, anyway, I'll end the video here, as you may have expected. Hopefully next time we have a positive. I really hate going negative for the day. You know, a loss or two is fine, but being negative is very upsetting. So, if you guys like this video on YouTube, like and subscribe. If you liked it on Twitch, follow me. I appreciate all of my followers. So, I'll see you guys next time.